TV6 presents the NCAA College Hockey Championship. The Michigan Tech Huskies meet the Golden Gophers for Minnesota in a rematch of last year's NCAA Hockey Finals. The following program is brought to you through the courtesy of these community-minded sponsors.
St. Louis University, Joe Ball, along with Roger Buxton, set to bring you the NCAA Championship game between the University of Minnesota's Golden Gophers and the Huskies of Michigan Tech. It's a rematch of last year's title game, Roger.
And it doesn't figure to be any easier for either team this year. You know, Minnesota beat Michigan Tech 4-2 in the championship game at the Boston Garden last year to win the NCAA title, and it should be a barn burner. Two teams from the WCHA, and really no love lost between them.
They split even during the regular season, each team winning two, so we expect that kind of a game tonight. We'll be back with the starting lineups for tonight's Michigan Tech-Minnesota NCAA Championship game in just one moment. Again, good evening from the St. Louis Arena, where Michigan Tech will meet the University of Minnesota for the NCAA championship. Joe Boyle, along with Roger Buxton, set to bring you all the play-by-play action. The University of Minnesota just coming out on the ice, and I'll tell you right now, and if you're watching the game in black and white, Michigan Tech will appear to have the dark uniforms on your screen, Minnesota the lighter uniforms. Michigan clad in the gold jerseys, University of Minnesota hockey team in the white jerseys with gold trim, but the Tech uniforms will come out as the darker of the two. It's the battle for the NCAA championship, a rematch of last year's title game won by the University of Minnesota 4-2, and it's a battle between two teams that between them already have identically broken the record for separate collegiate wins in a hockey season. And you get a chance to get an idea of some of the enthusiasm displayed by the crowd here in the St. Louis Arena.
Also the high regard with which they've seen sold each other.
Yeah, somehow the Badgers got in here. I don't know. The University of Minnesota, the old record for wins in a single season was held by Denver in the 60-61 season. They won 30, lost one, and tied one. So far this year, Minnesota is 31-9-1 on the year, and Michigan Tech is 31-10. So both already have recorded 31 wins, and one team will set a new collegiate record with 32 wins after this game is over tonight. So we're expecting a bang-up hockey game. The Gophers and the Huskies have met twice before. Tech lost at Minnesota 4-2-6-3. The Gophers lost at Houghton 7-0 and 5-4. We're about ready for the starting lineup, so here's Roger Buxton.
Michigan Tech, coached by John McGinnis, and the Minnesota Gophers, coached by Herbie Lutz. We'll have the starting lineups for you in just a moment. Now, there are a lot of incentives in this game for both teams, and we'll get into them as the game progresses. Well, the starting lineup for Michigan Tech. In goal tonight will be number one, Junior, from Altadena, California, Jim Ward. On the bench for Michigan Tech, number five, the senior from Downsville, Ontario, Bob Horner. Also on the bench for Tech will be number 18, Jeff Young, a freshman from Wallaceburg, Ontario. On the forward line for Michigan Tech, number 19, Steve Jensen, a sophomore, Minneapolis. Number 7, Mike Duke, the junior from Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. And remaining on the forward line for Michigan Tech, number 10, George Lyle, a junior from North Vancouver, British Columbia. There are the rest of the Tech players, and as we said, Michigan Tech coached by John McGinnis. Minnesota Gophers, they're in low rank, number 30. The guy in Minnesota, Larry Fair, he is a senior. On defense for Minnesota, number 3, sophomore from Hibbing, Minnesota, Joe Micheletti. The other defenseman, number 6, a senior from St. Paul, Minnesota, Les O.J. On the forward line for Minnesota, number 10, a junior from South St. Paul, Minnesota, Warren Miller. Number 7, senior from Hibbing, Minnesota, Mike Polich. And number 24, from Ballard, Minnesota, a junior, Buzzy Schneider. And the Gophers, of course, coached by Herbie Brooks. The Gophers are the defending champions. Now we'll pause for our national anthem. NCAA Championship game, the University of Minnesota, Michigan Tech.
Tech will be going right to left on your screen. Minnesota, left to right during this first period of play. Tech in the darker uniform. The helmets of the two teams will look identical. They both go. It'll be a little confusing out there until they get used to it, but I'm sure they've both gone through it before. Face off at center ice. Duke against Polich. The draw comes back to Laramore at the Tech blue line. He dumps it right back into the Gopher end. Warren Miller over after it for Minnesota. Hemmed in along the boards, and we'll have our first face-off of the game, and we begin to pushing and shoving early, and we might look forward to some of that throughout the night.
I think we may see quite a lot of that. Face-off to Fair's right. It'll be Zook against Pulling.
Crowd very alive. Both crowds follow their teams with a great deal of enthusiasm. Bryce Snyder from long range drives the shot, and Jim Warden handles that easily and dumps it off to the side. Wild throws it, but not out. Ogier with a shot that hits traffic out in front. Warden plugs it and hangs on. So we'll have a face-off now on the Michigan Tech end. Both teams getting early shots on goal and early action in both ends of the rink. And I think that's what a coach likes to see early in the game, everybody getting contact right away into the game. Again, Polich and Duke. Two fine centers. Two number sevens. They've met before, a year ago in the NCAA finals and four times during the past season. And the draw, nobody controlling it. Polich kicked it out in front of the net. The Farmore picked it up for Tech and steers it over on the far side. Tech out of their own zone. Les Ogier breaks that up for Minnesota. Puck dropped right back into the Gopher end. Hustle for it. A centering pass. Ogier has it, banks it off the boards, and gets it over to Polich for Minnesota. Polich, a rink-wide pass, too far for Miller. It caroms off the boards. Warden has to come out and steer it away from Miller. Ogier trying to hold it in. He goes down. Lyle in there for Tech, along with Zook. They battle. Puck lies loose. Lyle to the left side. Moving in. He cranks up and fires. And Micheletti goes down to block out. On the rebound. Lyle after it, but he slipped and fell. And Polich moving off to the side. He's going to have a penalty. Coming up against Minnesota. So there's a break in the action. They score. Minnesota nothing. Michigan Tech nothing. So just 1 minute into a hockey game. Michigan Tech goes to the power play as Buzzy Schneider goes to the penalty box for interference for Minnesota. Tech on the power play. Steele gets it over on the far side. DeVries drives the shot. Anderson and Wallimore go to the boards in the far corner, and the puck is cleared out of the Minnesota end down into the Michigan Tech zone, and they'll have to go back and pick it up. Back in the Michigan Tech zone, Austin with it, back of his own net, waiting for his teammate to get set, and he starts out. Willis to Austin. Drives the shot off the boards, picked up by Reed Larson, almost lost it. Reed Larson posting the defense for Minnesota, banks it off the boards on the near side, and Minnesota again throws it out of their zone. With a tough game Thursday night, they were behind at one time to Harvard 4-1. Score at the end of the first period of the second Boston University game was 2-2, and then pretty much Tech all the way. Puck in the Michigan Tech end. Back to the battle to Snyder. Michigan Tech very deliberate on their power play. Fair with the save off the long shot. And Reed Larson drives the puck all the way down the ice. Gordon has to steer it back of his own net. Waits for a back there. Tech picks it up. The puck for Michigan Tech. It's Paul Jensen, leader of the Michigan Tech. Puck out at center ice, picked up by Minnesota. Tech Pippen tries to clear it behind him. He can as he's checked into the board. Still has it holding it into the Tech end, and now it's picked up by Zook. Zook with it. Comes across his own blue line. Pippen knocks the puck off his stick, but he regains possession. 25 seconds left in the penalty time, and we have an icing call, so they'll bring it back down into the Michigan Tech end for the faceoff. With now 22 seconds left of the penalty time for the Bryce Snyder. Good job on that so far. Going in penalty seconds in the penalty department. Trying to get a play on the Tech end. This one just outside the Tech blue line. That'll be Zook. Zook and Dahlheim to face it out. Outside the Tech blue line. On the draw, Zook gets it back to his defenseman. With it, Jim Murray. Murray in his own zone. Starts back out. The center ice with the puck. Up the right side of the rink. Dumps it in. Back of the Gopher net. Race for it. Lyle with a shot that goes back of the net. Over on the far side. Younger tries to center it. Picked off and dumped down the ice by Wes Anderson of Minnesota. Minnesota back at full strength now as Schneider hits the ice. So Michigan Tech early in the game, unable to capitalize on a power play opportunity. Michigan Tech with the puck in their own zone. They get it over to Wild. Wild dumps it off the center ice to Zook. Wild is dumped. Puck in the Tech zone. A shot. Loose puck out of the front. Picked off by Morrow of Minnesota. Banks it off the board. And the puck cleared out the center ice. Tech will have to go back and regroup. Minnesota picks up the puck. Loses it to Younger. Younger moving in the right side. Lost control of the puck. Steve Jensen after it. They bang away. Loose puck out in front. Zook after it. Goes into the corner. As the puck knocked off his stick by Robin Larson of Minnesota. We're going to have a penalty coming up, and now we're going to call against the Wild of Michigan Tech. 23 to go in the first period, and now Minnesota will have their first power play opportunity of the night. That will be an elbowing call on George Wild of Michigan Tech. Time of the penalty is 3:37, so Minnesota with the first power play opportunity of leading. Watch it again. You see Wild on the boards just tired. There is the elbow come up right there. Faceoff will come outside of the Minnesota blue line. Decker in there for Tech. Now one by Minnesota. Reed Larson with it. Larson avoids the check by Decker. Moves to center ice. Still has the puck. Feeds it over on the near side. Gets it to Robbie Harris. Brings it out to the blue line. Polich with it out there. Has it knocked off his stick. Regains possession of it. Dumps it into the corner. Tech out after it. Along the far boards, they bang it up against the boards, and we'll have a face-off there. 1:38 left in the penalty time. It's a while. Both teams now have had to play short one man. Michigan Tech has not finished their stretch with it yet. Minnesota able to kill off the two-minute penalty time. We'll see what Tech does here. On the draw, it comes back to Young, and he dumps the puck down the ice for Michigan Tech. Minnesota will have to go back and regroup. Scott Jesse back checking in the Minnesota zone. Almost got it away from Reed Larson. Larson gets around another check. Still has it. Puts it over on Robbie Harris. He fires. Warden has a little bit of trouble with it. Steers it off to the side. Along the near boards, the puck comes loose. They battle for it. Fly it up along the near boards, and we'll have another faceoff. This one in the Michigan Tech end. 15:38 to go. First period of play. 1:15 left in the penalty to Wild. Minnesota will change units here. They send out Tom Youngins, number 9. Matt Pippen, number 11. Tom Finale, number 15. Joe Micheletti, number 3. And Les Ogier, number 6. Tech with Jesse, number 24. Young, number 18. And we'll pick up the rest of the unit for you momentarily. Here's Pippen. He drives his shot. That hits Young in the shins. Pippen goes back and picks up the loose puck. Moving in again. Dumps it back of the net. Return pass to Pippen. He shoots one. Makes the save. Pippen's made a stab at it. But he couldn't get it down on the ice level. And Tech throws it out in front. And here comes Tech back. Michigan Tech with it. Decker had the puck knocked off his stick. He and Youngins went down. Puck dumped down into the Minnesota end. That's an offside pass. And we'll bring it back to the Michigan Tech blue line for the faceoff with 49 seconds left in the penalty time to Wild. Neither team able to capitalize, but Minnesota with a chance right there. As you take a look at the Minnesota goalie, Larry Perry, he's a walk-on. Was not recruited. Brad Kjellstedt was the Minnesota goalie a year ago. They tried a couple of other goalies. Then walked on, wanted a chance, and they went through five or six games, and finally Perry got his chance, and he's been the regular goalie ever since. Puck driven down the ice by Abbey. Bruce Abbey for Michigan Tech. Perry drops it back to the net. Wes Ogier, senior defenseman from Minnesota, drops it for Tom Bonelli. Bonelli back to Ogier. Ogier checked out of the play, but the puck comes back and picked up by Bonelli, or Micheletti. Micheletti dumps it down into the Michigan Tech end. Jesse clears it out to center ice, picked up there by Younger. Younger moving in, can't get his stick down on the puck, collides with Micheletti and loses possession of the puck. We may have another penalty. Ice kicking, and it's probably be against Minnesota. It'll be Micheletti. So there's a break in the action to score. Minnesota nothing, Michigan Tech nothing. Micheletti of Minnesota gets the penalty, two for high sticking at 5:16, and it's pretty obvious right there. Not too much gripe about that one. Back to the live action. Well, these were the shot off the faceoff. Both teams are four skaters in the next 20 seconds, and then Michigan Tech will move to the manpower advantage. Andy back in his own end to pick up the puck. Bruce Abbey back at his own net. Wheels, that will just kill off time until they regain full strength, which is right now. So now Michigan Tech moves to their second power play opportunity of the night and an offside pass. There's a little stretch. They had an awful lot of pushing and shoving so far in the hockey game. Neither one of these teams about to back down from the other. You can pretty well bet on that. They're familiar with each other. They both like to play a physical game.
I think we get a good idea of the contrast in styles here tonight in our first game, Harvard and Boston University. Incidentally, Boston, you beat Harvard 10-5 to take third place in the first game this evening. Very much a skating game, very few penalties. We expect a good deal more contact in this event.
Cut picked up by Bruce Abbey of Michigan Tech in his own zone. He caught a stick high on the eye in Thursday night's game, and there was some doubt about whether or not he'd play. This is Mike Parrish of Minnesota, backhand shot, and that's steered to the side by Warden. Now here comes Tech out. Zook up the center, the All-American center from Michigan Tech with a high shot that caroms up into the crowd, and we'll have a face-off now in the Minnesota zone.
Joe mentioned Bruce Abbey, he's number 22 for Michigan Tech. He's wearing a plastic shield around the front of his helmet tonight. In that game against Boston U, he got a high stick and suffered a scratched eyeball. There's some question as to whether or not he'd be able to play. There you see him on his back. He's just a bit of a mask on his side, but he's all right. He's playing this game.
Zook and Youngman's on the draw. The puck comes back to the blue line. They feed it over on the near side, get it to Steele. Now here's Abbey with it. Centering pass, that's deflected off to the side by the pass is deflected into the corner by Delvis, and the Gophers play it down into the Tech zone. The Huskies back after it. Abbey leaks it away from one man. Steele has it and dumps it back for Abbey. Youngman's checking in the Tech zone right now. Puck goes on the far side. Tech with it. Delvis with it. Zook up the right side. Goes Jensen, dumps the puck into the corner. Reed Larson after it. Jensen puts it off his stick. Out to the point. Delvis a drive. That hits traffic out in front. And here comes Minnesota back. The three skaters abreast. They get it over to Reed Larson. Larson trying to go around. As Reed Larson carried down, Warner finally took him out of the play. Now here comes Tech back. They're on the power play. Reed to the Minnesota blue line. Punch up and fires. And Tech gets the shot. And Tech gets on top of the puck. And Russ Anderson. And Tech collides. And he's right by the edge of the net. They have a few words down back of the net. God loves it. Get a chance to look at it again.
Touch it again. There's the shot by Zook. There had some problems with it. It dropped down between his legs. You'll see it just kind of fall over backwards and cover up. Now Zook and Anderson will come through again right there. Anderson, you can see Zook's one leg up in the air, and there he goes.
Whistle had already blown. Minnesota and Michigan Tech changing here. Young kicks out for Tech. Now it's for Minnesota. Now Dahlheim comes out for Minnesota. Minnesota makes two changes. 17 seconds left in the penalty time to make a ready. Puck out to the point. Warhammer dumps it in. Comes out front. A shot. And that's steered off to the side by Fair. As Mayer got the shot off for Tech in the corner. Morrow battles for the puck. It comes right to the crease. As Bouchard shoved it through there. But the Tech players could not get their stick down on it. Minnesota's back at full strength. So they have successfully skated off their second manpower shortage problem of the night. Puck dumped to the Tech blue line. Knocked down there by Young. Young steers it off on the side. Tries to get it over to Roberts. Peter Roberts up the near side, and we have an offside call. 12:30 left to go in the first period of play. Score, nothing-nothing in the battle for the NCAA Championship. And I'll tell you, this crowd is about ready to explode. The first goal that comes will bring an awful lot of noise in this ring. There's a look at the Michigan Tech band. Hired in all this satirical splendor. Puck dumped into the Minnesota end. Now Morrow picks it up for Minnesota, being checked out front by Bouchard. He goes back to the net, still has the puck, puts it out on the stick of Lambert. Head hands it over to Vanelli. Puck knocked up into the crowd inside the Tech blue line by Roberts, so that'll bring a face-off in Tech territory. They'll change here, so there's a break in the action to score. Michigan Tech nothing, Minnesota nothing. the faceoff, the puck jumped into the Minnesota end offside, and they bring it back outside the Minnesota blue line for the faceoff. Nice score in our hockey game, and so far, Roger, it's been about what we expected.
There you see a shot of the Minnesota band. Not quite as conspicuous as the Jet band, but it certainly is valid.
Faceoff outside the Minnesota blue line. The puck comes back into Minnesota territory. Robin Larson with it. Steers it rink wide. Puck set out through the blue line. Picked up by Lambert, or Bo Schneider, rather. He points up and fires. He's wide to the right. Puck steered off to the side by Warden. They trap it up along the boards, and we'll have a faceoff in Tech territory. Tech with Dana Decker out there right now, along with Jim Murray, Scott Jesse, Jeff Wilcox, and one other skater we'll pick up in just a minute here. Can't see his number from here. The draw controlled by Michigan Tech. Jesse after it quickly, and he sends it down to the Gopher end. Robin Larson after it, and after him is Dana Decker. Robin Larson still has the puck. Gets around to check, carries on to center ice. Robin Larson carrying up the right side. Still moving in on his backhand, trying to center it. Right through the crease, they're coming up the loose puck. Robbie Harris had a chance at it. He's knocked down behind the net by Murray, no call. And the puck comes loose in the hands of Jim Murray. Get knocked right back into the corner by Holmgren of Minnesota. Knocked away from him by Lambert into the far corner. Now Murray after it for Michigan Tech, held in by Harris. Puts it over in the far corner. Wait for it in a little. Wilcox banks it off the board and hits one of the linemen. Roddy Harris with a shot picked off out in front by Murray. He banks it off the board. Then it's picked up by Decker. Decker up the left side for Tech. Gets it out front. A shot! And it's fair. Pulled away from in front by Robin Larson and picked off now by Roddy Harris. Stu Austin was the man that got the shot off for Michigan Tech. And now here comes Minnesota back to the Tech blue line. Moore with it. Dumps it out in front of the net. Holmgren couldn't get there. Over skating the puck that time was Mike Pilich of Minnesota as it lay loose for a moment out in front of the net. Puck fired behind by Schneider of Minnesota, and he dumps it into the Michigan Tech end. Quickly Tech back after it. Jensen picks it up back of his own net. Spins away from the check by Pilich. Pilich kicks it out. Warren Miller after it. Pilich deeks away at it. Now Jensen back after it for Tech along the near boards. They dump it right out in front of shot into the Nicoletti, and Warden puts his gloved hand in the air and hangs on to that one.
Good place by Minnesota. Played a lot of time in the check end here. Nicoletti's shot didn't get too much on it. Looked like he got under it and jumped up and was fluttering when Warden made the glove stop. Watch it again. Here you see Nicoletti moving in. Didn't get very much on it, but it started to rise. Warden made the glove stay with it to hang on. Face off to Warden's right in the deck end.
On the draw, Pilich and Zip bang away at it. The puck comes loose. Pilich after it. Jensen takes him out of the play. Schneider a shot, and that's wide to the left on the far side. Miller over after it for Minnesota. Drops it behind him. Pilich has a tearing pass. Played away from him, shot by Jensen. Knocked out the center ice by Zouk, and Oje picks it up for Minnesota. Gets it over to Schneider. He dumps it into the corner. Pilich goes in behind the net. The puck comes all the way around. Oje drills the shot, and that hits Zouk out front. A battle in the far corner. Pilich comes away with the puck. Tried to get it out front. Comes to Oje with it. He takes a shot. He's wide to the right with it. Minnesota putting on good pressure right now. Schneider trying to dig it out back in the net. He and Pilich both there. Pilich in the near corner tried to center it. Knocked off his stick by Abbey. The puck comes around the boards. Oje trying to hold it in. Dumps it into Pilich. His shot hit traffic. Another shot as he tries to center it. Warden gloves it and hangs on. As Miller, Schneider, and Jensen battled out in front. 9:35 left to go in the first period of play, and for the last minute and 22 seconds, Minnesota has kept the puck successfully in the Michigan Tech game.
Here's our starter, Jim Warden. He's been at this before, so it's nothing new to him.
He's a big guy, 6'3", 190 pounds, a junior, Canadian by birth. Resided quite a bit of the time in California, but strangely enough, went to a Twin City, Minneapolis-St. Paul area school. He was a goaltender at Wake in the Twin Cities. A shot by Reed Larson hits traffic, knocked down by Younger. Tried to feed Delvis as he broke up the ice, but that was cleared right back in by Minnesota. Warmer, the puck comes out to center ice. Now Reed Larson picks it up for Minnesota. Dumps it over to Youngins, and Youngins backhands the pass to Benelli. Benelli deeks away from one man, but Warhammer takes him into the boards. A battle for the loose puck continues. It comes across the blue line. Minnesota will have to go back and regroup. Off the boards. Pippen can't catch up with it. Picked up by Anderson. Anderson tried to get it on the side to Youngins, and Benelli picks it up for Minnesota. Tech forcing it deeper towards Minnesota territory now as they try to get it out on the side to Younger. Picked off by Youngins. Reed Larson fanned on a pass. Younger overskated the puck. They battle along the near boards and tie it up at the blue line. 8:46 left to go in the period. No score yet.
Been a good hockey game at this point. Some good chances. And some good hitting, some good physical play. Both teams taking the body pretty effectively. I'm sure the kind of hockey that both these coaches, John McGinnis and Roy Brooks, like to see.
The draw controlled by Lambert, and he dumps it back into the corner. Robin Larson with it there, feeds it over on the far side. Puck picked up by Holmgren. Paul Holmgren tries to go around a couple of puck defensemen, but is picked off by Delvis, and the puck fed up the far side now, and picked up over there by Steele. Steele takes the shot. Morrow in front of him. Now he scores!
Time is 11:36 from a seemingly impossible angle. You'll see Steele just put the shot on net. Just put a wrist shot right on. Steele comes over to cover it, but can't handle it. The dribble's going right between his legs.
Got the lower left-hand corner and went in. Michigan Tech leads it 1-0. The Tech crowd loves it. Puck in center ice now for the faceoff. On the draw, the puck comes back in with Michigan Tech in. Quickly back after this Missouri. Clears it out to center ice, all the way down the ice, and this will bring an icing call as soon as Minnesota catches up with it. There's a break in the action. They score. Michigan Tech 1, Minnesota nothing. Faceoff will come now in the Tech zone to the left of goalie Jim Warden.
The Michigan Tech goal, Bill Steele got the goal, but Doug Young time was 11:36, exactly 1-0.
Puck jumped into the near corner. Murray goes in there. Puck comes loose. Battle for it still. Picked up back of the Minnesota wing by Murray. He ties it up along the boards and we'll have yet another faceoff. Well, these two teams met last year in a classic battle out in Boston. Minnesota winning the NCAA Crown 4-2 there. We'll see what happens tonight. Tech has the lead for the first time in a hockey game. And here come the Huskies back again. Up the right side, Richard, and we have an offside call. So they'll bring it back outside the Minnesota blue line for the faceoff. 7:54 left to go, first period of play.
Minnesota makes a change. Portage, Miller, and Schneider on a forward line. Micheletti and OJ come out of defense.
Roberts, Richard, Mayer up front.
Here we see a shot of John McGinnis, the Michigan Tech coach. Talk about John when we have a moment.
Puck comes out to center ice. Mike Polich with it. He dumps it down into the Tech end. Murray and Miller race after it. Miller takes Murray into the boards. Puck picked up by Minnesota. They bring it out to OJ at the point. He cranks up and fires. Oh! That's the traffic and Kent Warden didn't see it. And it's skidded off to the side. Puck goes into the far corner. Polich jams it in along with a couple of the Tech players. And now Polich comes out swinging. As he's jammed into the boards, the officials get in there. Polich after one of the Tech players. Now he's talking to Murray. And now we have another altercation going over in the far corner. Warren Miller and Mayer battling. Roberts has grabbed one of the Gopher players as they kind of square off. We'll see whether anything is handed out here. I believe we're going to have some penalty time. Polich is still talking. Now Les Ogier of Minnesota has a hold of one of the Tech players. And I can't get the, that's Decker, or Roberts.
Wait, Miller and Mayer are going to go. I don't think anybody else will be involved. There you see Miller try to jam into the short side. Warden knocked it away. Now you see the action going into the corner. Polich got into it right here. You see the elbow come up. And the action between Miller and Murray started away from the play.
Well, he was trying to get into it with Bouchard, who jammed him into the boards after the whistle blew, and somehow he and Mayer ended up together. So the dancing partners were separated. 7:33 to go in the first period of play. Tech leads it 1-0. Polich is still out there. He hasn't gone. Now he's over talking to one of the officials. Now
don't know what this discussion centers around. Bruce Abbey is over getting into the conversation for Tech. Well, while they get this squared away, they'll tell you that there's 7:33 to go in the first period of play. Tech has scored the only goal of the game. Bill Steele, as Roger pointed out, with a shot from an almost impossible angle that it seemed that Minnesota goalie Larry Thayer had handled, but it seemed to elude him and get between his right arm and body and then trickled into the lower left-hand corner of the net. And that was enough, and Tech led it 1-0. That's the way the score still stands. Thus far, it's been a good hockey game. They had some pushing and shoving, but not much of the chippy variety.
I imagine the penalties are going to be roughing anywhere. They're both at 12:28 for Metairie, Minnesota, and Murray at 10.
We'll both get 2 minutes, so you're probably right, Roger. Probably roughing. Face off in the Tech zone, controlled by Zub. He's checked from behind, loses the puck. It's picked up by Joe Micheletti in Minnesota. Mike Polich is still out there. So it was not Polich that went. Roy Miller went. He and Mayer got mixed up over in the far corner. So the two original antagonists did not even leave the ice. Puck in the Minnesota end. Errant pass, almost picked off by Tech. Polich has it at center ice. Gets a pass back with Ogier, picked up by Zup. Zup got it behind Jensen. Bruce Puck picked up by Ogier, poked into the Tech zone. Polich after it, but Jensen gets there for Tech first. Schneider picks it up for Minnesota, dumps it out front. Schneider has the puck for Minnesota. Drop pass for Polich. Polich has the puck, being checked from behind by Zup. And finally, puck driven into the Tech zone. Minnesota wanted to make a change. Now Abbey picks up the puck for the Huskies of Michigan Tech. Trying to hit Jensen with a pass a little bit too far. And the puck comes to Tom Vanelli. His pass is deflected, and Pat Pippen cannot quite get to it. Coach Jensen out of the way. Vanelli with a drop pass and an offside call. Reed Larson could not get to the puck in time. Minnesota was a little slow in changing their defenseman, and there was nobody out at the point at the time the pass was dropped. 6:27 left to go in the first period. 54 seconds left in the penalty time to Jim Mayer of Michigan Tech and to Warren Miller of Minnesota.
Faceoff just outside the Tech blue line. Delvis will take the draw against Vanelli.
Puck comes back to Reed Larson. Dumps the puck into the far corner. Worden out to stop it. Leaves it for Young. Young feeds the puck to Delvis. Delvis hits the left side. Carrying on. Drives a long shot. The Fair had some trouble with handling. Into the far corner they go. Steele, who has the only goal of the hockey game in there. The puck fed out to Minnesota. Pass comes over to Reed Larson. Larson has one of the best shots in collegiate hockey. He drove one there, just wide to the right. Vanelli is puck checked out of the play, and the puck picked up by Steele. He gets it over to Young. Young carries to the Minnesota blue line. Carries in. Puts a shot through the crease. The Fair let go. Steele picks it up, dumps it into the corner as he's checked out of the play, and Reed Larson picks up the puck. One of the Gophers, Russ Anderson, has lost his stick. Puck comes out to Pat Pippen. Pippen for Minnesota, starts back. Gets it out to Vanelli. He can't control the pass, and it's cleared away by Young. Puck dumped in. Both teams are at full strength now. Pass just a little errant as they tried to get it to Miller, who was breaking for the slot, but he couldn't get in there. Real wrestling match going on now between Steele and one of the Gophers. Right on the front row, Holmgren can't control it. Bangs away at it. Vanelli bangs away at it. It's cleared off to the side by Young. Young steers it out to center ice. Anderson can't control it. Now he steers it over to Reed Larson. 5:07 left to go in the first period. Puck scored out front by Michigan Tech. With it was Osmond, he couldn't control it. Now moving in the shot, and he drives it up with it. And Scott Jesse fired it up there. Tech putting on the pressure now. Puck poked loose by Reed Larson for Minnesota. Larson up the right side, drives the shot that Worden steers into the corner. Minnesota making some changes. Puck tied up along the near boards. There's a break in the action. The score, Michigan Tech 1, Minnesota nothing. On Michigan Tech's Dana Decker. So he'll go to the penalty box, and Minnesota will go to the power play. get a chance to look at just exactly what happened off that faceoff.
I'll watch it again. There you see Holmgren going into the corner along with Murray. The puck will come loose and a tripping call will be coming up right here. There you see it right there as Lambert goes down.
Minnesota super tripping.
Harris, Lambert, as you take a look at the Minnesota bench and Coach Herb Brooks. Reed Larson out there, Mike Povich, Larson and Povich man the points.
The title difference, excuse me, though, the title difference is 15-27.
Look up the other wing for Minnesota before you in a minute. Tech has Scott Jesse, Jim Murray, Stu Younger, and Bob Lauren are out there on their penalty killing unit. Puck cleared down the ice by Michigan Tech. Minnesota will have to go back and regroup. Younger giving chase. Reed Larson picks up the puck behind the net, right out in front of it. Almost lost it off the end of his stick. Now here comes Minnesota back. Puck steered into the corner by Rob Harris. Tried to steer it around the boards. Comes out to the point. Reed Larson drives. It's Karpik out in front, and it's picked off by Murray. Two Minnesota players there, but they couldn't get their sticks down on to deflect it. Puck picked off by Minnesota. Povich has some trouble with it. Back in his own end. 1:25 left in the penalty time. To Dana Decker for Michigan Tech, and Minnesota moving back to the attack. Holmgren dumps the puck in, steers it into the corner, catches up with it, steers it in behind the net for Rob Harris, knocked away from him, battle for the puck. Minnesota picks it up, Lambert with it in the near corner, trying to get things set up, dumps it off for Harris. Harris moving in, still has it, drops it out to Reed Larson. He drives the shot, a backhand shot by Holmgren goes wide. Holmgren now. Larimore go after it, and the puck's cleared out the center ice by Michigan Tech. And Scott Jesse drives it down into the Minnesota end. Reed Larson back to pick it up with 49 seconds left in the penalty time. To Decker. Larson moves to center ice. Feeds the puck up the left side. Larimore after it. It's knocked away from him by Holmgren. They go to the far corner. They fall, and we'll have a face-off in the Tech zone. 3:10 left to go in the first period. 37 seconds left in the penalty time. To Decker, and Minnesota hasn't done much with this power play.
Steele comes on for Tech, and Nicoletti and Ogier go on for Minnesota. They'll play the points in the power play. Faceoff will be to Wharton's right. Now Young coming on also for Tech.
Finale and Del Hase on the draw to the right of Tech goalie Jim Wharton. And a whistle. Somebody in the circle too quick. Youngins for one for Minnesota and Steele for Tech. One of the officials comes over and says, uh-uh. Again, the draw to the right of Wharton, controlled by Del Vise. Checked from behind by Benelli. Puck comes loose. Tech has it, and they clear it down the ice. A race for it now as Del Vise catches up with it. OJ back in front of him. Del Vise around one man, and Ferris steers the puck back of the net. OJ clears it over on the far boards. Youngins with it. Has his pass stolen out in front. Puck knocked back of the net. Ogier back to pick it up with just 16 seconds left to go in the penalty time to Decker. Michigan Tech doing a good job of killing off penalty time here. Comes to the blue line. Povich got it by one man, but it's an offside call. So the faceoff will come outside the Tech blue line with just 9 seconds left in Decker's penalty time. There's a look at that mask worn by Abby. Bruce Abby. Kind of a plastic affair that goes over his eye. Covers the whole front of his face. Somebody was talking to me, Rod, or to us, I guess, about that mask. I can't remember where. But he was going to go take a look at it. I can't remember. What type of a mask that covers the entire facial area for the young kids? And they'd like to see younger kids to avoid stitches and eye damage. Wear that during the early hockey playing days. Puck comes into the Tech end. Pippen around behind the net with it. Michigan Tech back at full strength. Puck comes out to the point. Micheletti partially fanned and a shot. Loose puck right out in front. They walk away out of the shot. That's deflected as it hits traffic. Back of the net, Minnesota has it. Moving in is Benelli. Tried to pass it out in front. It's poked away. Ogier trying to hold it in. Knocked down. Benelli has it. Still has the puck. Waiting for some help to arrive. Puts it right on Del Vise's stick. Knocked away. Picked up by Michigan Tech. Wild with a pass. Coming up the far side. Steele. He shoots. Ball fair. Comes out. Makes the save. And the puck cleared away at the last minute by Micheletti. Benelli picks it up for Minnesota. Tech putting on pressure now. Benelli picks up the puck. Moves out to center ice. Puts it on the stick of Youngins, or Robbie Harris, rather. Couldn't get it to him. Benelli with it. Drops it behind him. Picked off by Pat Pippen. Pippen moves across the blue line. Steers it over on the side of Youngins. A backhand shot goes wide to the left.
Beckover. Now it's on a clear it out. They tie it up along the boards with 1:42 left to go in the first period of play. We have another faceoff in the Tech zone.
That's the toughest stop of the game so far right there, Joe. Once they get right here, you see Steele ahead of everybody.
Dunyer's trying to catch up with him, but Steele maintains good control of the puck. But he hit there right the pads.
There's another look at that mask worn by Bruce Abbey. Face off in the Tech zone. And right out in front, Miller with a shot. That hits Abbey in the legs, goes between them, a centering pass. They wrap away at it. Warden clears it away from the side of the net, and they tie it up back at the net along the boards, and we'll have a face off. Another close call right there as Warren Miller had an opportunity, but his shot hit traffic.
It's been one of those periods, I think, where Minnesota's had the better chances, but Tech has got the goal.
Alan Tech is playing, I think, probably a little better the defense in their own end. They've had defensemen right out in front of the net for the most part. They've kept the puck pretty well cleared away from in front. Brad Morrow from Minnesota pokes it up for Schneider, knocked away from him. He holds it in, picked up by Michigan Tech. Miller checks Zook out of the play, but now here comes Jensen on his backhand. He shoots it over the top of the net into the glass, and the puck's picked up by Minnesota's Warren Miller. He loses it behind the net. Lyle, a backhand shot. He fanned on it. Put those right through the crease and over to the far side. Another centering pass by Jensen. Picked up by Minnesota. Jensen still hit him again. Puts it right up front. They score. Zook! Jensen perfect over the two of the hockey game. The ball comes with 12-4 left to go in the first period of play.
Watch it again. Steve Jensen will put it right on Zook's stick.
A lot of hard work by Jensen.
Pretty goal here for Tech. You see, they got him 2-on-1. He's got the defenseman down right now. There's the pass, and Zook just slams it home. Player tries to get over, but has no chance as he puts it over his leg.
A lot of hard work by number 19, Steve Jensen, to set up that goal. Did a lot of checking in the Minnesota end, and Tech now leads it 2-0. On the draw, the puck comes back to Russ Anderson from Minnesota. He drives it back into the Tech zone. Murray after it. Holmgren knocks it away from him. Lambert after it. Lambert jousts with Murray. The puck comes back in the net to Holmgren. Picks it out. Steers it off to the side. It's picked off by Bouchard. Bouchard feeds it up ice and hits Roberts with his pass. He overskates it as Reed Larson took it away from him. Puck picked up. Moving in as Michigan Tech. They shoot there. Makes the save. The puck cleared away from in front as Mayer had the big chance for the Huskies that time. Tech putting on good pressure now here in the last minute and a half of play. Puck picked off by Anderson of Minnesota. Dumps it over on the far side. A race board now with 30 seconds left to go in the period. Cleared out the center ice. Picked off by Reed Larson. He dumps it into the Tech end. It's picked off there by Wilcox. He dumps it down into the Gopher end. Minnesota back after it. Reed Larson gets away from a check by Roberts. Steers it up along the boards. Gets it up to Lambert. Lambert puts it on Holmgren's stick. He can't control it. Puck right back down into the Minnesota end by Murray. And time running out in the first period. Just 6 seconds left to play in the period. Puck comes to Reed Larson. Larson steers it out at center ice. And that's it. So the first period comes to a close with Michigan Tech holding a two-goal advantage. And Roger, why don't you recap the scoring?
Scoring in the period, Michigan Tech's Bill Steele from Doug Young at 11:36. And Tech's Mike Zook from Steve Jensen at 18:56. A lot of penalties in the period. Buzz Schneider of Minnesota for their appearance at 1 minute. George Lyle of Tech for Alvarez at 3:37. Joe McAmuddy of Minnesota for high sticking at 5:16. And Warren Miller of Minnesota and Jim Mayer of Tech both went for roughing at 12:28. Finally, Dana Decker of Michigan Tech for tripping at 15:27. Shots on goal in the first period. Tech had 9 and Minnesota had 7.
Okay, that pretty well sums things up. 9-7 shots on goal. It was just about that kind of a period, a two-shot difference and a two-goal difference at the end of one period of play. That's the end of the first period. The score, Michigan Tech 2, Minnesota nothing. Mike Zook against Mike Polich. Two number sevens, both have the same first name. Joe Micheletti drives the puck down into the Michigan Tech end. Tech trying to clear it out, held in by Snyder of Minnesota. Del Vista over to get it, has it knocked away, and Warren Miller takes a shot that goes wide to the right, and the puck goes back of the net. Warren steers it around the boards. Wow, goes up along the boards along with Warren Miller, and Povich is held from behind. Looks around. Faceoff will come to the Tech end. 2-11. Michigan Tech leads it. Close first period. Tech with the edge in shots, 9-7. The Huskies holding a 2-0 lead right now. Championship game in the NCAA tournament here at the St. Louis Arena. Face off to the left of Wooden. Povich wins the draw for Minnesota, but lost the puck, and it's picked up by Michigan Tech. They keep it out to center ice. It comes to Jensen. Jensen puts it on Zip stick. Puck picked up by Minnesota. Jose throws it out to center ice. Pucks over the top of the stick to Roy Miller, and it's regained by Tech. Wild comes it to the blue line for Zip. He's kept out of the play by Micheletti. A shot by Jensen, and third was that and hangs on. 19-22 left to go, second period of play. Let's watch it again. Here you see the shot. Straight to the rise. Clear made the glove save and elected to hang on at that point. This shot to the left. Minnesota goalie right there. Down Beast. Now we're on the draw. The puck out front. Shot fired up there by Steele. Another shot. That hits traffic. We have a whistle. And we may have a penalty. If the interference against someone, will get the call. I think it may be on Abby, but I'm not sure. While we hand it out, there's a break in the action. The score, Michigan Tech 2, Minnesota nothing. Minnesota goes to the power play out in front. Tom Jenkins with a shot. And Wharton steers that one on the side. Bruce Abbey has gone to the penalty box for Michigan Tech. 2 minutes for interference. Part of Abbey's penalty was 46 seconds. If you did a double take, he's taken that mask off that he was wearing in the first
game. Yeah, he has. I think it probably made it by
the face off outside the Tech blue line. Comes to Mike Povich. He steers it over on the side. Reed Larson dumps it in for Minnesota. He's right on. Warden steers it way out in front, held in at the blue line by Povich. He colors, and Warden got the stick down on that and steered it for power. Good shot by Povich and a good save by Warden. 1:25 left in the penalty time. Abby, watch it again. Warden tried to clear it himself, but Povich flagged it down at the blue line, just snapped off a quick shot, got it on the net. And there you see the stick saved by Warden. Puck comes out to Reed Larson. He fires that. It's perfect. He's headed for the lower left-hand corner. Comes out to Povich. He dumps it into the corner. Settling pass. And a finger cut. That Pippen hits traffic. Comes out to Reed Larson. He fires the shot. That hits traffic out in front. Povich after it. Sends it around the boards. And over to get it as well. He's to Michigan Tech, and he drives it down the ice. 1 minute left in the penalty time to Abbey. 18-15 left to go in the second period of play. Up comes to Minnesota, flipping up the right side. It's not a burst of speed, but he's
flipping his club.
Right, yep.
All it takes is a phone call.
Vanelli in there along with Pippen, they tie it up and we'll have a face-off. Face-off will be to Warden's left. We'll see Warden out of the net to talk to one of his teammates. He may have allowed 5 goals the other night, but he's been caught tonight. He's met with some 5 brilliant saves early here in the second period. Well, it should say that those last 2 goals came in the game as well out of reach. He was playing 3 at that point. And one of the other goals by Boston University was a disputed goal. Face off to the left of Jim Warden. McGraw, Holmgren gets it out to the point. Gophers with it. OJ winds up and fights as he hit Holmgren in the back of the legs with his shot. Paul Holmgren of Minnesota tries to tie it up. Puck dug loose, and it's cleared down the ice by Michigan Tech. It's right on goal, and Larry Fair has to make the save. Watches Jesse coming after it. It's dug away from him by Micheletti. Micheletti trips and falls. Jesse after the loose puck. Has it. Will try to steer it out to center ice if he can. Pam Minnesota, he's going for the Gopher goal. It trips and falls. And the puck picked up by Joe Micheletti of Minnesota. He's taken into the boards. Puck comes to Warmo, who drives it back into the Minnesota end. Oje steers it out to center ice. They put it on Lambert's stick. Lambert around one man, trying to get around Young. He's held from behind. Center hit, cleared away from in front, held in by Harris. Warmo back at the net after it. Taken out of the play by Harris. Minnesota comes up with it. Right on the cross, and on the pass. Picked up on the far side by Abbey, who's back out on the ice. Michigan Tech back at full strength. Minnesota dumps it into the Tech zone. They drive it right back down the ice. This will bring an icing call. No, it will not. As Michigan Tech catches up with it first, they feed it out to the point. Mayer with a shot, and it goes wide to the right. Now moving in on it is Young. He overskated the puck. Dumps it out in front, picked off out there by Ferguson for Minnesota. As Minnesota using a fourth line now temporarily. Puck picked up by Michigan Tech. They jump it out to center ice. Now here comes Michigan Tech. Right back to Scotty. Hit the side of the net with it. The shot fired in there by Roberts, and he hit the side of the net. Now here comes Varon up the right side. He's got the man trailing on the play. Fires the shot. Picks up the rebound. On the near boards, overskates the puck. Michigan Tech over to get it. They clear it out to center ice. Morrow rink-wide's a pass. They dump it up to Dahlheim, and Dahlheim drives the puck into the Michigan Tech end. Warden stops it back in the net. They steer it out on the near side for Bouchard. Picked up by Tech. They clear it out to center ice. Fredrickson, that one, we're after it for Minnesota. Puck comes down into the Minnesota end. Robin Larson after it. He drops it for Varon. Varon steers it up for Fredrickson. Has it bounce off his skates. Almost picked up by Paul Jensen of Tech. Puck comes right out in front, and Brad Morrow clears it in front. Gophers still with the puck, but it's in their own end, as Tech's pretty well fired up right now. The Huskies drive it right back in again. Morrow picks it up for Minnesota and dumps it down into the Tech zone. Warden has some trouble handling that. Relatively easy shot. Jensen steers it around the boards and is driven right down to the Minnesota end, and this will bring another icing call as soon as Minnesota catches up with it. There's a break in the action. The score of Michigan Tech 2 and Minnesota nothing. At the center ice. We've been asked by some of the Minnesota fans to pass along greetings to a young man that did not make the trip for Minnesota. Jim McCoy, who was injured prior to the start of the playoffs, the best had to do is stay home in Minnesota to watch the game, and it's always tough to do so when your teammates are playing for the national championship. Michigan Tech with the puck. Jensen with it, dumps it into the Minnesota end. Picked off by Minnesota, knocked down out front by Tex Rostlin. His shot goes wide, but Lefty tried to hit one of his teammates breaking across the net and could not. Puck poked loose, Minnesota comes up with it. Now Warren Miller starts back for Minnesota. Moving in on his backhand. Tries to get behind the net, does. Dumps it out to the front. Reed Walson, partially playing on a shot. Then he has his second attempt blocked. And he comes back with a 3-on-2 break. Jensen moving in, a drop pass. Back to Jensen. Oh, the puck is good. They score! Wow! Good foul! Jensen will get an assist. And I believe Austin will. Let's watch it again. Tech making it look easy at this point. They didn't get over anxious. We're going to see a nice pass right here. Lyle cruising into the left side. Jensen puts it right in his kick and bingo right there. And it's 3-0 Michigan Tech. 5:21, the time of the goal. And the Husky winners are happy. Puck comes to the blue line. Micheletti picks it off for Minnesota. Oje drives it down. Here's Benelli. Has it knocked off his stick. Coming to the shot. And that's kicked out by Warden. Warden has been superb in going so far for Tech. Puck in possession of Minnesota. Steele dropped it out. Now here's Gophers up the right side. Moving with his backhand. He shoots there. Makes the save and clears it off to the side. Puck comes to the near boards. Gophers out to the point. A shot taken there by Jensen. Goes to the far corner. Younger ties it up along the far boards, and we'll have a face-off. 14:11 to go in the second period, and Tech with a commanding 3-0 lead right now. That could be tough for Minnesota.
Tech is not the kind of team you can fall 3 goals behind and come back on very easily. Puck comes in the draw. Back to Minnesota's Les OJ. He's checked by Delvis, but comes away with the puck. Still has it. Comes loose on the near side. Picked up by Minnesota. They hit man it for Vanelli. Vanelli's pass deflected. Picked up by Micheletti. He lost it. And Fippen has it now for Minnesota. Fippen with a headman pass too far for Youngins. It goes the length of the ice. They wave off any icing. Abbey back after it. Youngins takes into the boards. They tie it up there and we'll have a face-off. Tempers come up. Abbey and Youngins push at each other. But nothing's going to develop out of it. And now one of the Tech players came up and wrapped his arms around Vanelli, who's the smallest man on the ice. I don't know who it is. One of the officials has him by the shoulder. Not Abbey. Abbey and Youngins just kind of walked away from each other. It's Steele. Bill Steele. Well, he's not much smaller than Vanelli. Steele's 5'7", 170 pounds. Later, Vanelli is 5'8", 160, so about 10-pound difference.
Well, they're going to reorganize here. The faceoff will be the Warden's left.
13:47 left to go in the second period of play. Here's what led to that scuffle. Really not too much between Abbey and Youngins after the initial pushing and shoving. Now there's Benelli, running his own business in the section. Still going at him. Face off to the left of Gordon, comes right out front. Tech picks it up. Here comes Steele back. He already has one goal to the Minnesota blue line. Trying to go around to Tech. He's shoved to the ice by Moore. Puck cleared out to the blue line. Warner with a drive into the far corner. Nice shot deflected wide to the left by Younger. Back of the net, they batter. Puck comes loose to Moore of Minnesota as Holmgren was tied up with Delvis. Puck comes to the near side. Harris with the lead pass out front for Lambert. Lambert can't control it. It's picked up by Minnesota. Here's Holmgren with a shot deflected. It goes to the corner. Lambert after it. Has some trouble controlling the puck. They'll try to tie it up. Tech will change here, so there's a break in the action to score. Michigan Tech 3, Minnesota nothing. On the draw, the puck comes out to center ice. Carried on in by Minnesota, but Tech comes right back with it. Here is Roberts to the Minnesota blue line. Harris steers that to the far corner. Morrow with it, dumps it right out in front. Comes across the blue line, and Tech will have to go back and regroup. Wilcox has it for Tech, dumps it right back into the Minnesota end. Gavin Larson with it for Minnesota. Defending NCAA champs, and they're down by 3-0 to a hustling group of Huskies from Michigan Tech. Puck comes off the near boards. Lambert drives it down to the blue line. Wilcox drives it right back into Minnesota's end. And it's tipped into Paul Holmgren. Holmgren can't control the puck. Now it's picked up by Robbie Harris. He shoots and runs out and hands on. Jim Morton. He's been the difference in this hockey game, I think, right now, Roger. He looks very strong right now, looking very confident. Watch it again. Here's the shot by Harris. Get the load of the ice. Wharton get the glove out. He's playing very well. Face off to the left of Wharton. Bowich and Zook again on the draw. Bowich gets the draw. Comes out to Russ Anderson. He shoots. That hits traffic out in front. Montoya with a shot. He hit traffic and it goes up into the crowd. I think it was Wilcox that got his stick on it. One of the Tech defensemen did. 12:22 left to go. Second period of play. Here it is again. And there he is, puck out in front. It was Abbey. Bruce Abbey takes the deflection for Michigan Tech. That pass outside. So that'll bring the faceoff out at center ice. Tech with a 3-0 lead. They finished as runner-up to Minnesota in the WCHA race. Last year, the situation was reversed. Minnesota finished his runner-up to Tech at the WCHA race, and it was Tech that won the NCAA crown. Zook collides out front with Anderson. Zook goes down. We had a whistle and an offside call.
Faceoff will come outside the Minnesota blue line. Again, Zook and Polich. Polich gets the draw back to Anderson of Minnesota. He dumps it out to center ice. Zook has it. Dumps it in, and we have an offside call. It was obviously offside. It was wide, about 4 or 5 feet. Tempo of the game really has not slowed much throughout the first period and a half. Tech has had some opportunities. They have cashed in on them. Minnesota has had opportunities, but Warden's been able to thwart them each time. Ron Miller with the puck, being checked by Lyle. Still has it, drives it out to the blue line. Polich has it, can't pick it up. A shot by Jensen, deflects it, they shoot. Oh, and Lyle fired it right into the side of the net, but we had had a whistle prior to that, as Tech was called offside, so it would not have counted had it gone in. Well, that looked like another big chance for Tech right there. Minnesota, totally dominating at this point. Yes, they are. Minnesota has been caught with one of the Tech players behind their defenseman. And that's cost them so far. Puck cleared out to center ice. Randall over after it. He drives it down the ice. Race for it back there. Kovacs and Jensen go to the boards. Delayed penalty. And Michigan Tech. Lyle is going to go to the penalty box again. Tipping the call. So Minnesota has another power play opportunity. How long Michigan Tech can keep putting Minnesota on these power play chances? You can go to the well once too often, but so far, when their defensemen have not been able to keep the puck clear of the net, Jim Warden has. Take a look at the penalty. There you see it right there. Now, play continued on down the ice, but the delayed penalty had been called at that point. Of course, the play continued until Tech gained control of it. Marion Steele on the draw. Draw control by Tech, and they clear it down the ice off the faceoff. Race for Reed Larson. And Jesse, Larson is hit from behind by Jesse. Puck picked up by Polich. Larson took a swipe at Jesse as they went by. Larson with it. Reed Larson, freshman defenseman, feeds it over on the near side to Youngins. Youngins puts on the steam, being checked from behind. Puck comes loose. Warden steers it off to the side. Puck comes out to the point. Larson winds it up. Oh, and Warden made the save and jab away at the loose puck, and Warden's on top of it. And Warden wants a piece. The light went on. Right over the net, and they have scored.
The light is on. You see, I don't know what happened exactly.
Puck is in the net.
Puck is in the net.
Now, let me have some discussion about this. Warden had the puck under his glove. Somebody may have jabbed it loose. We're not going to call it a goal yet.
I don't think it's going to be a goal.
The puck is in the net, and that's all the goal judge has to account.
I think the official mayor got
official.
No goal. We'll see it again. There's he working with a stop. The puck is loose at this point. Everybody takes a swipe at it.
The referee
loose. They're loose the side of it at this point. And the whistle is blown. I think you're going to come in and see it dribbling between his skates.
Well, we didn't see it, but it's in the net in the red
light. There it goes right now, but the play had already been whistled dead.
Youngins after it. Minnesota on the power play. They get it out front, knocked away by Young, and it's picked up by Lowell. He dumps it out to center ice. Reed Larson picks it up there. Comes to the blue line, has the puck knocked off his stick. Picked up by Polich, knocked away from him by Jesse. A couple of players go down, and here comes Michigan Tech out with the puck. Tech with it. They dump it in. Jesse and Polich go back behind the net. Puck comes around, fed to Reed Larson. 1 minute left to go in the penalty. To Lyle. Here's Pippen moving in. Checked out of the play by Young and just tossed to the ice. Linnelli digs back to the puck. Dumps it back of the net. Youngins gives chase. Tries to drop it over on the far side to Linnelli. Linnelli moving around. He shoots. That hits traffic out in front. Tipped up in the air. It comes down on the left-hand side of the net. Picked up by Youngins. Tried to center it. Has some trouble with it. Puck comes loose and Michigan Tech picks it up and drives it down the ice. 36 seconds left in the penalty time. A race now as Reed Larson goes back after it. He's taken into the boards by Jensen. Polich digs the puck out. Almost lost it. Came to Paul Holmgren and it's picked up now by Polich. Mike Polich of Minnesota. Rink wides the pass for Reed Larson. Just 20 seconds left in the penalty time to Abbey. That's stolen by Zook. Zook in the far corner as Minnesota gets careless again. Zook back of the net. Dumps it right out in front. Comes out to Young. Young lines it up and dumps it back into the corner. Zook with it. Down to 7 seconds left in the penalty time. Held in out there by Lorimer. He dumped it out. Paul Jensen set out now to Lambert. Michigan Tech is back at full strength as Young picks up the puck, banks it off the boards, held in by Lambert. He can't control it. Now he regains possession of it. Holmgren after it, dumps it into the corner. Young after it, he dumps it via the whistle, and what will be the goal?
Holmgren's gonna go.
Paul Holmgren. Now, wait a minute now.
No, I think they just called playing.
I thought he was about to shoulder with the stick.
They went up over the ball, so I think they were going to get it for a penalty. These are the slightly one of the 10 players, but no penalty, obviously. Here's the Lambert. But comes loose. Holmgren will pick it up right here. And they go to the boards. There you see the puck going up over the ball. It will come in the Tech zone because the Tech player put it up into the crowd. Up the draw, Lambert comes away with it, throws it into the corner. Abby takes him up against the boards. Centering pass comes loose out in front, picked off by Tech. They drive it out to center ice. Robin Larson picks it up there for Minnesota. Gets it over to Moore. Moore dumps it in. He's right on, and Warden handles that easily. Drops it back of the net. Abby taken into the board hard, and hold on, there's a delayed penalty coming up against Minnesota's Paul Holmgren.
I think it's going to be Robbie Harris. Go board.
Abby got hurt.
Now he's all right now. Seems to be shaking it off. So there's a break in the action. The score, Michigan Tech 3, Minnesota nothing.
Cleared away from in front of the net.
Puck held in by Jensen. Jensen gets it into Delvis. Jensen with a shot, and that's cleared away by Ogier. Sends a weak shot into the corner, picked off by Steele. Steele, centering pass, out in front. Delvis after it, out to the point to Abby. Abby with it. Abby feeds it over to Jensen, a little bit too far. Race for it. The Gophers bang away at it. Picked up by Minnesota. Ron Miller with it. Dumps it down into the Tech end, and Paul Jensen goes back and picks it up for Michigan Tech. 1:19 left in the penalty time to Rob Harris. Puck picked up by Jensen. Goes to center ice for Tech. He's checked out of the play. Regains possession. Delvis has it at center ice. Banned on a pass. Puck picked up. Nicoletti overskated it. Now Schneider pokes it off to the side. Miller picks it up. Moving in. He cranks up and fires. That hits Abby in these skates. Miller's still after the puck. It's picked up now by Zook. Zook brings it back towards the Minnesota blue line. Gets it up inside the Delvis. He shoots. Now gets the save. Couldn't find it for a moment. Then dunks it back of the net. They bring it out inside the Lorimer. Over on the far side. Abby drives the shot. That hits traffic. Zook had a backhander. He's checked from behind by Nicoletti. Nicoletti with it. He bends it off the boards. Abby can't hold it in. 39 seconds left in the penalty time to Rob Harris. Puck comes to Abby. Feeds it over on the near boards. Minnesota picks it off. They get it out to the blue line. Michigan Tech after it. Miller can't handle it. Now he and Steele battle for the puck. It goes down into the Tech zone. Miller dug it loose and dumped it into the Tech end. Michigan Tech with it. They try to hit Paul Jensen with it. Steve Jensen with the pass. 19 seconds left of the penalty. Micheletti carries on into the Tech zone. Still has it. Down he goes. Now the call, but didn't get it. And the puck comes off to Steele. Here comes Tech back. Last moment of the penalty. Jensen moving in his backhand. He's taken out of the play by Dahlheim. And the puck's back in the Minnesota net. Dahlheim with it. Takes it up along the boards. Doug Rose. Tech has it out. Come a backhand shot. Steers wide to the corner. After it, Tech. Wow with it. Feeds it out to the side. Minnesota back at full strength. Puck right out in front. They overskate it. Stops it. Tech still has it. Settling pass. Cleared away from in front. It's cleared out to center ice and picked up out there by Lorimer, who dumps it back into the Minnesota end. Loose puck just lays there, picked up now by Lyle, tried to steer it out to the point, had it deflected, regains possession, it comes right out in front, Pat Pippen has it for Minnesota, headmans it for Kolitz, Kolitz, big wide pass meant for Dahlheim, couldn't control it, it's dumped out to center ice by Murray, driven right back in by Ogier of Minnesota, puck on the attack end, Minnesota changing on the fly, puck comes out to center ice. Race for it there. Anderson back to pick it up for Minnesota. Weak pass. Comes back to Reed Larson. He hits one of the Tech players with his pass. Now Pippen puts it on the stick of Vanelli. And Minnesota starts back. Vanelli to the blue line. Around the screen. It's not passed for Youngins. He didn't see it. And it's cleared back out to center ice by Tech. We have a delayed penalty coming up. Now they wave it off. Now, there's no penalty. It was simply an icing call. But they waved it off. Now the puck picked up by Minnesota Stiffen. Stiffen trying to get it over to Vanelli. Vanelli moving in. A race to Ballmer. Stiffen after the puck. Tech picks it up. Steele gets it over on the side. Got it to Mayer. Mayer avoids the check. Carries on into the corner. Tried to center it. He's checked out of the play by Larson. Youngman has it. Youngman, they tie it up along the board. So there's a break in the action. The score, Michigan Tech 3, Minnesota nothing. Some trouble with it underneath his pads. Robin Larson steers it over to Moore. Moore headmans to Harris. Harris, a wink wide pass, picked off by Tech. Harris regains possession of it. Tech with a 3-0 lead. Puck driven into the Tech zone. We have 5:17 left to go in the second period of play. Michigan Tech dominating so far. Puck got up the rear boards. Jesse cruising in and an offside call as Robin Larson had gone down to try to block the shot. But we had the whistle and an offside call outside the Michigan Tech, or the Minnesota blue line.
Well, we find a lighter leading in the second period. Michigan Tech, at this point, looks as though one more goal, they might be gone. That's how well they're playing at this point. They have played well in their own end, and they've waited for the breaks in the Minnesota end, and when they presented themselves, they have taken them. Minnesota has had chances. But Jim Warden has been the difference so far, and the Tech goalie has been outstanding in his hockey game. Puck at center ice. Jumped into the Gopher zone. We have an offside whistle.
Face off again. Well, this time it'll come inside the Minnesota blue line. There, and landed on the draw. They bring it back to Wilcox. Wilcox leaves it over on the far side. A long shot. There watches that slide by the net. Picked up back of the net by Morrow. He's taken into the boards hard. Puck picked off by Michigan Tech. Holmgren sends Mayer to the ice. We have a whistle. And there will be a face-off in the Minnesota zone. 4:47 left to go in the second period of play. Michigan Tech with a 3-0 lead.
Well, you see Morrow. He goes under a check right there. Check comes loose in the corner. Holmgren moves in. They tie it up. The official will blow the whistle.
And I hope you're enjoying the game. I'm sure the fans of Michigan are. Fans of Minnesota right now not too happy with the way the score goes. The fans out of Boston, I hope, contend for seeing a good collegiate hockey game. For the national championship, the puck comes out in front. Pulled away by Dahlheim from Minnesota. He moves to center ice. To the Tech blue line, loses control of the puck. And the puck's cleared back out to center ice. Minnesota's had some trouble with their passing and their stick handling so far in the hockey game. Now here comes Tuck back. Jesse moving in. He shoots him down in front to block that one as Ogier. Puck right out in front. There's puck and skating by the side of the net as Mayer. He never got control of it. Fredrickson over to pick it up. Tries to trap it up along the boards. Ogier takes one of the Tech players into the boards. And now we get some kicking and shoving and pushing. Let the officials step in. Control things. And we don't get much out of that.
Tech is going to make a change. They'll send out a whole new unit at this point.
They send out Steele, Younger, Elvis. And let's see, Paul Jensen is out there. And who else? Abby. I guess that's it. Puck comes out. Delvis with a shot. He's wide to the left with it. Loose puck cleared out to the side by Minnesota. Picked up by Dahlheim. He clears it out to center ice. Banked off the boards. Picked up by Dahlheim. Minnesota had to get back onside. Loose puck picked up by Varant. Varant pokes at it. Now Dahlheim after it. Picked up by Steele. Steele being checked by Dahlheim from behind. Puck comes down to Minnesota. Blue line stolen by Delvis. Moving in. He shoots. He fired it wide to the left. Younger over after it for Tech. There's Michigan Tech controlling play right now. Back of the net. Delvis tried to stuff it in, but he had it slip off his stick, and here comes Minnesota back again. Dahlheim dumps it in. Berant races after it. He and Jensen.
Oh,
Berant comes away with it. A centering pass hit the net. Over on the far side, the puck comes loose. Over after it is Younger. Auger with him. They hold it in along the boards. They kick at it. It pops loose. Delvis has it and gets it out to Steele. Steele at corner ice just dumps it down into the Minnesota end with 3:28 left to go in the second period of play. Dahlheim around the boards. A little bit too far, and it's held in by Abbey. Picked off his stick. Abbey regains possession. He shoots, and he hit the side of the net with it. Auger with it. Steers it back to the net. Rob Harris comes over and picks it up for Minnesota. Joe Micheletti, rather, cleared out the center ice. Minnesota seemingly content right now to just try to keep the puck out of their zone as Tex putting on constant pressure. Auger with it. Hits Polich with the pass. Mike Polich, the senior center, moves to the Tex blue line. Puts on a burst of speed, trying to go around Warhammer. Can't settle. Is it a cut right out in front and cleared away to the side by Jensen? Picked up by Snyder. He drives a shot that's wide to the left, and Tex comes away with it. Tex clears it out the center ice. Picked up there by Reed Larson. He dumps it right back in. Warren Miller gives chase. Warren out of the net. Who's cut? Picked up. The Gophers couldn't control it. Tex comes away with it. Now they battle back in the net. We get a whistle and we'll have a faceoff. 2:36 left to go in the second period. Faceoff will come to the right of goalie Jim Horton. There's a shot that hit the side of the net. Faceoff comes to the right of Jim Horton, the Tech goalie. Draw one by Duke that time. Warhammer back to pick it up for the Huskies of Michigan Tech, having some trouble handling it. Cole is taking it from behind, wheels away from it, bumps it up the boards and gets it to Weil. Weil taken out of the play. Now the puck picked up by Warhammer. Gets it up the side to Duke. Duke trying to go around Lee Larson, loses it. They get it out to Warren Miller. Miller, on his backhand, sends a rink-wide pass to Bryce Snyder, and he drives it to the Tech blue line, knocked down there by Young, and he dumps it back into the Minnesota end. There, out of the net, leaves it. Loose puck comes off on the side. Snyder after it, steers it back into the corner with 2 minutes left to go in the period. Snyder with it. Minnesota needs a goal fairly soon if they're going to get back in it. Reed Larson banks it out to the blue line, held in by Young. His shot hits perfect. Anderson clears the puck away from in front. Held in by Murray with the shot. And Fair had to make the save on that one. Now here's Minnesota back to the attack. They dump it into the Tech zone. Minnesota wants to change. Puck driven back down the ice. And that will, no icing, they say. Robin Larson back to pick it up to Minnesota with a minute and a half left to go in the period. On the far side, Larson trying to dig it out. Taken out of the play by Roberts. Puck back of the net. Roberts digs it out in front of the shot. For the score! I believe it is Scott Dessing.
I think so. I'd like to give their points, I believe. Again, Minnesota loose in their own end. That's been their downfall here tonight. And in fact, goes to most of their talents against Harvard on Thursday night. You see, they get my tone. I think it hit the inside of their play that went in. Now their goal is 18-40. And Minnesota has dug themselves quite a hole. They're down 4-0 to a very strong Michigan Tech hockey team. Tech dumps it in. Fair back of the net. They steer it around the boards. Moore steers it further. Pippen picks it up. Gets it to Vanelli. Vanelli over to Youngins up the right side. He fires and he's wide to the right with his shot. Back of the net. Vanelli after it. Steers it out. Pippen picks it up on the backhand. He shoots. That hits traffic and goes back of the net with a minute left to go in the period. Youngins tries to stuff it in. It goes right through the crease. Puck picked up by Tech. Jesse clears it out to center ice. Vanelli over after it for Minnesota. Carries on in, gets it to Pippen, back to Vanelli in the corner. Vanelli with it, tries to steer it out front, comes out to Moore, he cranks up and fires, and that's deflected up into the crowd with 40 seconds left to go in the period.
Scott Jesse got the goal for Michigan Tech at 18:40 from Jim Mayer and from Peter Roberts. Faceoff will come in the Michigan Tech zone out near the blue line. Steele and Harris getting awfully close to the two participants of the draw. Lambert comes away with the puck, still has it, now he loses it. Picked up by Younger. Younger up the left side. Knocked off his stick by Auger. Auger wraps it behind him. It comes out to the blue line. They shoot from there, and that hits traffic out in front as Abbey took the shot. Came over to Holmgren. Comes to Lambert now. Knocked away from him. Paul Holmgren has it. Steers it up to the Michigan Tech zone. Abbey picks it off. Clears it out to center ice. Loose puck picked up by Micheletti. Micheletti has it. Knocked off his stick by Delvis. Now here comes Tech back again. Well, he drives a shot, and he's wide to the right with it. Harris trying to clear it out. Cleared out to the side by Micheletti. Lambert has it and clears it out to center ice. Picked up there by Tech with just 2 seconds left to go in the period. Shot fired wide. We have a whistle and an offside call. With 1 second left to go, all we have time left for is the draw. And Michigan Tech, with a leg over the saddle, so to speak, towards that NCAA crown. That's it. That's the siren as they drop the puck. And that's the end of the second period. Roger, to recap.
Story of the day, George Lyle and Tech from Steve Jensen and Stu Osmond at 5:21. And Scott Jesse from Jim Mayer and Peter Roberts at 18:40. Penalties in the period. Bruce Abbey of Tech went for interference in 46 seconds. George Lyle checked the tripping at 8:19, and Robbie Hurst of Minnesota for elbowing at 11:53. I'm sorry, I did not hear the shots on goal as they were announced over the PA. At this point, really, it seems a little incidental because Michigan Tech is playing so well, and Minnesota not playing well at all. Michigan Tech is very dominant at this point in the game.
So through two periods of play, Michigan Tech with a margin. They score after two. Michigan Tech 4, Minnesota nothing.
At least the crowd indicates that they are coming back on the ice. Here they are. In this case, the Michigan Tech with a 4-0 lead right now. In this third period, Tech will be going right to left on your screen. Minnesota left to right. While we have the chance here, we can thank our staff. The facilities provided by Blackleaf Communication Services. Our director has been Kent Samuel. The coordinator. Coordinators, I guess we should say, Jim Pence, Ron Geiselhart from WTCN in Minneapolis, and Al Potter of WGBH-TV in Boston. And we've also like to welcome the folks up in the Michigan area to our broadcast. You have a right now to be very, very proud of this Husky hockey team. They have played extremely well tonight. I think outside of the goalie play of Warden, Roger, if there is a difference, it's been the fact that Michigan Tech, I think, has played the better hockey game, at least in their own end of the rink. That's where Minnesota has dug their hole, is in the end, but they're defending. And Tech has been a little bit the better of the team in their own end, particularly.
I would agree. I think that's very much the story of the game. As we told, mentioned earlier, Minnesota had the same problem on Thursday night in their game with Harvard before they finally got on track. And they've had more of the same here tonight, so that's basically what's got them in the situation they now find themselves in.
Now don't go away. Still 20 minutes of hockey to go, and in hockey anything can happen. On the draw, Minnesota controls it, dumps it out to center ice. Lyle drives it right back in for Michigan Tech. Hoje back to pick it up for Minnesota. Has some trouble with the puck. Gets it to Warren Miller. He banks it off the boards. Picks up his own rebound. Steers it out to center ice. And then Young dumps it right back into the Minnesota end. They're out of the net. Lyle with the puck. A loose puck. They shoot. They're down to make the save. He's still down. The puck steered off to the side. Finally by Miller. Tech with it. Richard moving in. And coming up on Joe Micheletti. He will go for interference, I believe. Joe Micheletti will go to the penalty box, and Michigan Tech will go to the power play, and should they score here, that'd be tough.
Let's watch it again. You'll see Micheletti dump Zook right out in front of the net. It's coming up here in just a moment. There you see Zook in the crease, and Donnie goes right there. There you see the official with his arm up. Time of the penalty is 28 seconds.
So Michigan Tech goes to the power play at the outset of the third period. They already lead 4-0.
I don't think, Roger, that any of the Tech goals have been power play goals.
No, they've all been,
so we've had no power play goals scored, and both teams have had opportunities. So the penalty killing units of both teams have been very, very efficient so far. Steele, Zook, Warman, Wilcox, and I can't see the number of the player over on the far side. Most likely it's Delvis. Minnesota has Polich, Oje, Schneider, and there's still a player short. Only have three men out there.
Anderson coming on. So
Wes Anderson comes on. Bob Galvis is the fifth skater for Michigan Tech. 5-4 skating situation that favors Michigan Tech right now. On the draw, Polich gets it to Anderson. He dives it out to center ice. It's picked up out there by Lohmer. And he headmans the puck on the far board. He's trying to get it to Galvis. It's loose. Picked up by Minnesota's Mike Polich. Polich with it. Carries up the right side. He's got a man with him, but he could not get it over to Ray Schneider. The puck comes back into the Minnesota end. They get it over to Les Ogier, who carries it back of his own net. Almost lost it. Now banks it off the boards. Polich after it, but Lohmer gets there first. Schneider intercepts that pass. Lohmer over to pick it up. Being checked by Schneider from behind. Puts it on Galvis's stick. He takes the shot. Now he shoots, and Ogier goes down the block. That loose puck played away by Fair. Picked up by Zip. Gets it out to Lohmer. He fires. That hits traffic out in front. Picked up by Michigan Tech. They wheel around, steal with it, puts it beside the net. Galvis brings it out to Lohmer. Lohmer with it. On the left point, drops it into Zook. Zook moving in. He fires it over across the crease. Now here's a shot. Hit traffic with Dan. It's good. Galvis. Bob Galvis puts Michigan Tech up 5-0. And that could just about do it.
Watch it again. The time of the goal is 1:26. Galvis with the goal. Here you see the shot right there. If Fair makes a stop, it falls, and there's no way he can get back. Galvis just comes in behind and taps it in. Well, about all you can say is, with a 5-0 lead, Tech has got the door to the throne room well open, and it would take a miraculous comeback, certainly the greatest comeback I've ever seen in a hockey rink for Minnesota to pull this one out. They're down 5-0. Said earlier, though, they've been down before. Let's see what happens. Tech right now with a commanding 5-0 lead. This one after the puck drives it into the Tech end. Gordon back at the net. Abbey steers it clear, tipping over after it, trying to get it away from Jensen, but he can't. Steered out to center ice. Here comes Michigan Tech back 2-on-1. Drop pass for Lyle. Moving in. He shoots there. Saves. Loose puck out in front. Picked up by Benelli of Minnesota. Dumps it over on the far side, meant for Pippen. Jensen steers it back to his own blue line. Gets it back there to Paul Jensen. Now the puck picked up out front by Michigan Tech. A shot fired up there by Austin goes over the top of the net. Along the near boards, the puck comes loose, back of the net. They get it up at the blue line and out the center ice. Pass goes too far. They wave off on the icing. Paul Jensen after it. That's Pinelli after him. Trying to force the face off, and he does. There's a break in the action. The score, Michigan Tech 5, Minnesota nothing. Faceoff, the puck comes to Michigan Tech. Centering pass goes wide to the far corner, picked up by Harris of Minnesota. Puts it out on the stick of Lambert. Lambert on a backhand pass, a little bit too far for Holmgren. It's poked back out to center ice by Michigan Tech. Robin Larson picks it up there. Gets it over on the far side to Morrow. Morrow's pass for Holmgren, and he dumps it into the far corner. Morrow goes back after Michigan Tech. Check from behind, the puck comes loose. Holmgren centering pass, nobody there, and it's picked off by Michigan Tech's Peter Roberts. Roberts starts back to center ice, dumps it up the right side. Losing it is Bouchard, and the puck picked up by Lambert of Minnesota. Dumps it over on the far side. They bank it off the boards for Harris. Harris puts it on Lambert's stick, cruises in, but has the puck knocked off his stick, and Tech throws it again off the center ice. They'll go all the way down to the Minnesota end. Mayer and Moore will go after it. Moore gets there first, sends it around the boards to Rob Harris, and Harris fights back for Minnesota. Minnesota so far unable to crack the defense of the Michigan Tech Huskies and the goaltending of Jim Warden. Puck out at center ice. Tech right now content to just check and keep it out of their zone. Here's Younger after it, and it's poked away at the last minute. Moore clears it along the near boards. Minnesota with it. Lambert trying to put it on the stick on the far side of Harris. Poked away from Lohmer, and now hit from Harris, and down he goes, and that's going to go to a shorthanded situation. Puck comes loose, and Minnesota will go to the power play. With 16:20 left to go in the hockey game, Lohmer goes to the penalty box for tripping, And Minnesota has another power play opportunity.
Start with a penalty on Larmer. We can have a look at it right here. Time is 3:40. You see Harris going down.
And there's a look at Larmer in the penalty box. Minnesota has not been able to capitalize on the power play. Neither had Michigan Tech until the third period. Now we score. Thus far, Jim Wharton has been the rock of Gibraltar in the Michigan Tech net. Delvis to face off with Mike Polish. In the Tech zone, the puck comes out. Moving in Osher, he shoots that his time they got in front. Polish brings it into the corner after it moves in. Centers it. This puck on front. Wharton fouls to cover it up. Sticks coming from the air. As Steele and Miller got him up there, but nothing comes of it. Ball on the penalty box. For another minute and 52 seconds. Minnesota on the power play. And if ever a team needed a goal, Minnesota does right here. On the draw, the puck comes to Michigan Tech. Steele picks it up and clears it down the ice. Bill Steele's played a strong game for a freshman. Dumps the puck into the Minnesota end. Picked up back there by Schneider. Schneider sends it back of the net. Oh, he's a senior, excuse me. I said a freshman. Steele's a senior. Now here comes Minnesota back. Schneider, stick handling his way. Can't get around Abbey. He's taken into the boards. Steele picks it up and lofts it high in the air out to center ice. Minnesota will have to go back and regroup. 1:23 left in Larmer's penalty. Micheletti with it. Dumps it along with far boards. Miller carries it in, but an offside call. And Minnesota will have to go back outside the Tech blue line for the faceoff. 15:38 left to go in the hockey game. 1:18 left to go on the penalty. What if he's going to make a change? Kirkland Vanelli is young hands off for Minnesota along with Kovic and Reed Larson. Vanelli on the draw. Decker is off for Michigan Tech. Draw comes to Reed Larson. He dumps it up to the blue line to Pippen. Puts it on Vanelli's stick. He fanned on a shot. And through to pick it up is Youngins. Youngins moving in. Drops it back of the net. Centering pass just a little bit too far for Vanelli. It crosses the blue line. Minnesota will have to go back again and regroup. 1 minute left to go in Larmer's penalty. Now here's Vanelli moving in. A little bit too far, the pass for Youngins. Youngins trying to steer it away from Murray over on the far side. They pick it loose, but the whistle is already blown, and we'll have a faceoff in the Michigan Tech end with 52 seconds left in the penalty time to Larmer. Minnesota desperately needs to go. They're down 5-0. Michigan Tech 15 minutes and 12 seconds away from the NCAA title. On the draw, they battle. Pippen picks it up for Minnesota. Here's a shot to Polich, and Wharton throws that and hangs on. Another faceoff in the Tech zone with 46 seconds left. Minnesota has had some pressure on this power play, but Wharton has been tough. Puck hops over Polich's stick. Minnesota will have to go back and regroup. A real race now as Jesse moves down. Kerr fires the puck over to the far side, picked up by Pippen. He's decked. As coming up to hit him was Dana Decker. Now the puck comes out to center ice. Pippen went down from a check. Finelli carries on, looks for some help out to the blue line. Polich cranks up and fires. Wharton makes the save, pulls it in and hangs on. 19 seconds left in Larmer's penalty. And I don't think it's been the Tech defense that's held them out this time. It's been strictly Wharton. Minnesota's had some cracks at it. Get a chance to look at it again. We see Pippen go down to do a big check. Now Minnesota carrying on. There's Pullet just inside the blue line. He drives the shot. Wharton gets over to get the pad on it and scoops it into cover-up. I think that's about the fourth or fifth save that Wharton has made on this power play. Jensen picks up the puck, trying to clear it out to center ice. Morrow holds it in for Minnesota. Moving in, he cranks up and he fires. Wharton makes the save, and Abbey drives it down the ice. Just 8 seconds left in Larmer's penalty, so Tech has killed it off. Robin Larson puts it right out in front of the net and almost put it in the stick of a Michigan Tech player. Michigan Tech back at full strength. Puck carried in by Texas. There'll be no offside here. Puck out at center ice. Minnesota gets back onside, but the whistle blew anyway.
I think that was a little bit of a quick whistle because Minnesota had gotten back onside from up here, but it's easier to see from up here than when you're standing down there.
14-13 left to go. It's a hockey game. Michigan Tech with a commanding 5-0 lead. Fifth time these two teams have met. They've split even up till now. Puck on the draw, comes back to Morrow. He drives it right back in. Abbey picks it off, banks it off the boards, out to center ice for Lyle. Pass steered away. Now Tech picks it up, but an offside call.
Ball over to Minnesota. We'll get a penalty here for elbowing.
Okay, Valley double the penalty out. There's a break in the action. The score, Michigan Tech 5, Minnesota nothing.
Cooper elbowing for Minnesota at 5:55, so Tech on the power play.
And the Huskies converted their last power play opportunity. A similar event here, but just about put all the nails in the coffin as far as the University of Minnesota's hopes of successfully defending their NCAA crown would go. Puck in the Minnesota end, held in, we get a whistle, and playing the puck forward with a hand is the call, and it was by a Minnesota player, so the faceoff will come in the Minnesota end. There's a look at Mike Vallant of the Gophers, number 25. Face-off in the Gopher end. Zook on the draw loses it. The puck goes all the way back down into the Michigan end. Picked up down there by Lorimer. Lorimer with it. Tried to drop it. Nobody picked it up. Now Zook has it. Slowly to center ice. Mike Zook, and Tech way offside as Delvis is in, and that brings the whistle. He was looking for the pass. Didn't get it. And thus was about 4 or 5 feet offside. 1:21 left in the penalty time to Paul Holmgren. Minnesota skating shorthanded. Coach Herb Brooks decides to change his men up front and send Schneider and Polich back out there. Hold on. Comes off for Minnesota. And Dahlheim comes off for Minnesota. Draw controlled by Michigan Tech. Joe Micheletti after it. Picks up the puck, moves back at his own net, looks for a spot, finds it, and picked off by Michigan Tech. They get it over on the side. It's Steele, fair down on the loose puck, and he gloves it and hangs on. And Steele has the stick knocked out of his hands by Micheletti, but the officials step in. 1:09 left to go in the penalty to Paul Holmgren. That Tech band has been going a lot of the third period, Roger.
Yeah. We're going to look it up right now. Let's watch it again. Here you see Steele moving in. Tries to jam it between Thayer's legs. The puck comes up and he catches it in the chest.
Steele took a whack at Thayer, and that's what brought the wrath of Joe Micheletti down on him. Faceoff will come to the right of Minnesota goalie Larry Thayer. 13-14 left to go in a hockey game. 1:09 left to go in the penalty time to Paul Holmgren. Minnesota taking plenty of time right now on these shift changes. Osklin went out to say something to Murray. On the draw, the puck comes to Lyle. Abbey with it, trying to drop it back in. It's kicked loose. Abbey picks it up, gets it over to Lyle. Lyle trying to dump it in the corner. Retrieves the return pass. And back in, shot, he scores! Lyle! His second goal of the night, and Michigan Tech leads it 6-0. Another power play goal for Tech. And that should just about do it. Let's watch it again. You see Lyle go to his backhand. He gets it up high, and it went over Thayer's shoulder. See, going right there. It's a rising shot. Went through traffic. I guess it went under his arm. I beg your pardon. It wasn't as high as I thought it was, but it went through a lot of traffic. 6:56 the time of the goal. That's a power play goal. Larry Thayer having a rough night, not due entirely to his own faults. young man that through most of the season led the WCHA in goaltending statistics. But he's had six big ones pounded by him tonight. And again, all of them cannot be laid at his doorstep. Puck comes loose, picked up by Tech, and they drive it down into the Minnesota zone. All play around, fired after it, tried to center it. Warren Miller picks it off for Minnesota. Miller trying to feed a pass up the right side. Knocked down. We're going to have a penalty coming up on Minnesota. And it's going to be on Warren Miller. High sticking, I believe, as he caught Osman with the stick. So there's a break in the action to score. Michigan Tech 6 and Minnesota nothing. The puck comes to Lyle. Moving in, we may have another penalty coming up here. Anderson's going to go as well. So Russ Anderson is going to go. I think holding will be the call on Anderson. So now Minnesota has to play two men short. See if we can pick up the penalty again. Anderson is number 17. Right there, here you see the penalty call. I suspect it will be holding. That's at 7:21. The Minnesota will be 2 minutes short. So the faceoff will come to the right of Larry Thayer. And here in the third period, every time Minnesota has gone a man short, Michigan Tech has scored. They've had two power play opportunities prior to this, and they've converted both of them, their first two power plays of the hockey game. And right now, Minnesota finds themselves 3 men short. So John McInnes, although nothing is definite on it yet, may be closing out his career at Michigan Tech with an NCAA title. Certainly looks like it right now. Puck comes out to Murray. Murray gets it over on the far side to Wilcox. Wilcox out front, a shot by Osman. That hits traffic out in front. Osman retrieves the puck. Ogier checking him. Lyle comes in to pick it up. Feeds it out to the point to Murray. He cranks up. Gets it over on the side. Wilcox blasts from there. Fair saves. Rebound cleared away to the side by Micheletti, who picks up the puck, tries to clear it out. It's held in by Wilcox. He has it stolen away by Polich. Now Mike Polich to the Michigan Tech blue line. Cranks up and fires. That's knocked down by Murray. And Warden steers it back of the net. Puck comes loose. Picked up by Tech. And they start back again. Long pass picked up by Ogier. Ogier tried to get it on the side to Polich, could not. Lyle picked it off, and here comes Tech back again. Drop pass and an offside call as Osman was lining it up. They rule that Jensen was in offside. .104 left in the penalty time to Miller, and .115 left in the penalty time to Russ Anderson. Minnesota, 2 men short. Pat Pippen comes out. Louis Polich will go off. Reed Larson comes out, and Wes Ogier will go off. Puck comes on the draw over to Lorimer, who drops it for Young. Young carries on into the Minnesota zone. Reed Larson in front of him, takes him up to the boards. Puck comes loose, comes out to the blue line, held in out there by Roberts. He dumps it into Young. Young moving in, drops it out front to Roberts. Roberts avoids the check, gets it over on the side to Young. Young moving in, Minnesota 2 men short. They drop it back of the net. Little back there, Lyle comes out to Young. Link wide pass goes on the far side, and Bouchard could not handle it. Still has the puck, though. Dumps it into the corner. Tech moving in again. Back of the net with it. Lyle brings it out on the side to Young. Young trying to line it up. They drop it out to the blue line. A shot from there, and it goes wide to the right as Lorimer fired it. Comes back out front. A shot out front by Roberts, deflected as it hits traffic, goes to the side. Bouchard picks it up, knocked away from him, it comes out to the blue line, and it comes across the blue line, and that's an offside call. 8 seconds left in the penalty time to Warren Miller, and 19 seconds left in the penalty time to Russ Anderson. 10:58 left to go in a hockey game. Tech with a great big 6-0 lead. Thank you.
remember that now.
They're weaving back and forth down there. Having a ball. Up comes to Reed Larson and banks it off the board down into the Tech zone. Minnesota will have one man back right now, so they're only one man short. Puck out for Boulon, held in by Ogier, picked up by Abbey. Rich Abbey starts back for Michigan Tech. We have 2 seconds left on the penalty found to Anderson, and now he's back on the ice, so Minnesota is back at full strength, and they have successfully killed off a two-man short situation. Puck held in out there by Jensen. He cranks up and fires. That hit traffic out in front. Cleared off to the side by Minnesota. Youngins try to clear it out. Gets it down to the Tech blue line, where it's knocked down by Jensen. Comes back to Ogier at the Minnesota blue line. Ogier spins away from the check, still has it, fires it out at center ice. Youngins can't pick it up, but it is picked up by Minnesota. They get it over to Youngins. He fires, he scores! Tom Youngins breaks up the shutout that has been fashioned by Jim Warden, and Minnesota's on the boards. Let's watch it again. Here you see Pippen with it, puts it on Youngins' stick. Feed him to the far side. Right there, kept it low to the ice. Morton didn't get the leg over. Time is 9:49. Pippen will get an assist. Excuse me, Joe. Minnesota finally breaks the ice, and it's now a 6-1 hockey game. But it's late. 10:11 to go in the game. 5-0 lead for Michigan Tech. Won't go away. Here comes the Minnesota on the draw to get it up to Benelli. He tried to steer it over to Pippen, could not. Now here comes DeVise back for Michigan Tech. Moving in, he tried to go around Reed Larson. Centering pass off on the side. They shoot. Ball makes the save and hangs on. Steele with the shot. They're made the save. Pippen and Steele have a few words. Les Ogier getting an assist on that goal along with Pippen. 9:57 left to go in the game. Faceoff will be in the Minnesota end to Clear's left. Austin will take the draw for Tech.
Minnesota goes for the number 9, Tom Willard.
See who will take the draw. Brad will take the draw for Minnesota. Brad Fredrickson and Dahlheim out there, fourth line for Minnesota. Shot taken by Wilcox, hits traffic. Another shot by Tech goes wide to the left. Minnesota trying to clear it out. Fredrickson fired it right onto the stick of Wilcox, who dumps it right back into the Minnesota end. There behind the net to stop it. Head around the boards by Robin Larson. They get it over to Tom Dahlheim. Dahlheim off the boards. He meant to pass for Brown, but couldn't get it to him. And the puck comes right back into the Minnesota end. Brad Morrow with it. Over to Robin Larson. Larson feeds it out across the blue line. Picked off there by Wilcox. Now here's Tech moving back. Decker with it, has it knocked off his stick. Overskating it is Morrow. He's taken into the boards, and that brings the faceoff right there. There's a break in the action. The score, Michigan Tech 6, Minnesota 1. On the faceoff, the puck goes back of the Minnesota net. Les Ogier after it has some problems, still has the puck, however. Head mends it, now carries on and dumps it to the blue line. It's cleared away from the attacking Minnesota squad by Murray. Puck dumped again to the blue line, held out by Abbey. Now they get it up front, and it's picked up by Wilcox. A drop pass for Ostlund and an offside call. We have 8:56 left to go in the hockey game, and it would take a near miracle for Minnesota to pull this one out. They're down by 5.
Tech is going to change. Suk is out along with Lyle. Steve Jensen, Young is out. And also Larimer.
Lambert, Holmgren. Puck comes on the draw to Micheletti. Dumps it down for blue line. Tech picks it up there. Young has it. And he just dumps it right back down to the Minnesota end. race for it now. Osland after it, but Micheletti gets there first. Sends it around the boards for Harris. Harris puts it into Lambert's skates. They bring it over, and it goes behind the man for whom it was intended. That's Ogier, knocked down at the blue line by Lyle. He drills a shot there, makes the save, and then taps it up against his chest. 8:32 left to go in the game. Time running out for the Golden Gophers in Minnesota. And a title getting nearer for the Huskies of Michigan Tech.
Here's a shot again by Lyle. You'll see Beard taking high in the chest.
He dropped down into it and trapped in his sweater. That's where the whistle was blown and suspended the faceoff. Faceoff to the right of there, controlled by Minnesota. They clear it out down towards the race point now. Miller after it. And back to get there first is Warren. Therefore, Michigan Tech. Miller takes him into the board and trying to force the faceoff, and that's exactly what he does. That'll bring the faceoff in the Michigan Tech end to the left of Jim Warden. Shooting will take the ball for Michigan Tech and pull it for Minnesota. Puck in the Tech end, kept in by Robin Larson. Out front to Schneider. He tried to poke it loose, and now here comes Tech back with Zook leading the way. Zook. He takes the shot, there comes up. Jensen tries to jam it loose. Reed Larson is really decked from behind. I think he got an apology from Lyle, who crashed into him because he backed off on his challenge right away. Larson's really decked. Watch it again, you see Zook will get the shot. It's a good one away, right on the net. There's Z. Larson. Face off to Thayer's left. On the draw, the puck goes into the corner. Anderson sends it back of the net to Reed Larson. Larson trying to put it on Polish's stick. He has some trouble with it. Dumps it out to center ice. Warren Miller can't control it. And is driven right back into the Minnesota end by Roberts. Now the puck comes to center ice. Polich drops it in. Race for it. Warren Miller gets there first. He's taken to the boards by Abbey. They battle along the near boards. Miller goes down on top of Abbey. And Mayer also there. Schneider there. Now Miller gets a little hot. He's trapped up along the boards by Bouchard until tempers calm down. And we'll have a face-off in the Tech zone. Goalie Jim Warden out there, and he got a penalty for roughing the other night, the Boston U game. So he's not afraid to get into things. 7:47 left in this hockey game. Hope you've enjoyed it. Wherever you are. The draw controlled by Vanelli. Youngins with a shot that just went behind to the right. Abbey steers it around the boards. Morrow holds it in. Pippen back to give chase. Abbey gets their first protect. Dumps it up along the near boards. Morrow, Robin Larson. Now Pippen with a shot. Roberts over after it. He takes it away from one of the Gophers. Puck held in. Picked up now by Abbey. Knocked off his stick by the Gophers. Pippen after it. Has it knocked off his stick from behind by Abbey. Puck held in. And now it comes out to center ice to Bouchard. To Mayer. Mayer up the right side with it. He's got Roberts breaking for the net. Couldn't get it to him. Picked off by Pippen. Right out in front. Picked off by Bouchard. Now Youngins with it. Rink wide the pass to Robin Larson. Larson puts it on the stick of Vanelli. Vanelli to Warren Miller. Moving in on his backhand. Pippen with it now. Hits Robin Larson. He can't control the puck as he collided with one of his own teammates.
Delayed penalty.
And we have a delayed penalty coming up. The Minnesota net is empty. Polich after the puck. Youngins with it now. Youngins wheeling around. A delayed penalty coming up on Tech. They get the stick on it, poke it loose. That will not bring the whistle. Tech never had control of the puck. That's what it requires. Puck comes on the near side to Holmgren. Picked up by Polich. Polich moving to the blue line. Drop pass on the far side for Minnesota. Still with it is Tom Vanelli. Being checked, he drops it behind him to Morrow. Morrow pokes it into the corner. Warden goes up against the glass. He's trapped there, and a couple of the Gophers get in there. Now all the Michigan Tech Huskies get in. We have a little bit of a tussle going on. Mayer pulled out of there by Morrow. Some swipes being taken, and the guy that took him, Jim Murray, just went down with one of the Gophers. Morrow on top of him. Well, we'll get things sorted out here. There's a break in the action. The score, Michigan Tech 6 and Minnesota 1. Okay.
Right.
The time of the penalty. Pollock is in for Minnesota. I think Warden also got a penalty in that disagreement there, because one of the Tech players has gone to the, or two Tech players in the penalty box, and I think one of them is in serving Warden's penalty.
Oh, you had a shot just a minute ago of the Michigan Tech crowd here, and they've begun to sing Goodbye Gophers, and I'm sure the Minnesota fans here in St. Louis don't like that, and I'm sure that the Gopher fans back in the Twin Cities don't like it, but it's pretty much hit for tat, as the saying goes, because last year the situation was reversed and the Minnesota fans began to say the same thing to the Huskies in Boston Garden when Minnesota won the NCAA crown. This has been a great rivalry over the years, and I don't think it's going to change over the next few years, because these are both young hockey teams and they'll have a lot of players back for a long time to come. There's a look at goalie Jim Lund. He is getting wiped off, and he may have taken a little bit of a swat on the top of the head down there.
Minnesota will get a man advantage when all this is sorted out, because Portage is in for the Gophers, Murray and Mayer both in for Michigan Tech.
The penalty is on Mayer and also on Jim Murray. Now Minnesota was going to get a power play anyway because of the delayed penalty. They controlled the puck for a long time but never really got a shot on goal out of it. I don't know if you can pick up this Michigan 10 crowd or not, but let's see if we can. The band playing, the fans are ecstatic down there. They're having a ball. There they are. The Huskies of Michigan Tech. They're living it up tonight to St. Louis.
Yes, indeed they will. They are, they will.
There's a look at Jim Horton.
Well, he's a dominant player in this game.
Yes, he has been. No doubt about it. And unless things change in a hurry, he could just call it, played himself into the most valuable player award in the tournament, because I think, without a doubt, he has been the outstanding difference in his hockey game. Minnesota has had their backs at it, but that young man has, all but one occasion, kept them out of the net. Right there. .628 left to go in the game. Michigan Tech leads it. 6-1, Minnesota goes to the power play. Polich in the penalty box for Minnesota, Mayer and Murray in the penalty box for Michigan Tech, so it's a 4-on-3 situation. Important draw here for Minnesota. Steele will take it for Michigan Tech against Pennelly of Minnesota. The draw comes back to Pippen for Minnesota, so Minnesota comes away with the draw. Gophers have the puck. Moving in, they drop it out front to Reed Larson. He picks up, drives a shot, and hits traffic. Picked up by Pennelly. As the puck gets it out front to Larson. Larson trying to get it over on the side of Pennelly. Does so. Pennelly with it. Moving, he drives a shot. That's deflected. Pippen after it. Poked away from him. They go to the near corner after it. Pippen comes away with the puck as he gets it away. And it comes across the blue line, and Minnesota will be called for offside as Reed Larson could not hold it in. Good job done for Michigan Tech there by Warmer. Michigan Tech has Steele, Young, and Warmer out there in their penalty killing unit. Pennelly gets the draw back to Reed Larson. Larson sends it over on the far side for Les Ogier. He carries on, has it knocked off his stick, but Pippen holds it in, gets it to Reed Larson, dumps it right out in front. Pennelly can't handle the puck, and he and Lorimer go down on top of it. It came loose, but the whistle had already blown. 1:17 left in all three of the penalties, so Michigan Tech a man short for the next minute and 17 seconds. 5:45 left to go in the hockey game. Minnesota changing here. They sent Lambert and Harris out along with Larson and O.J. Right now, Minnesota may be stick handling a little bit too much. They've just got the pepper warden and hope that something goes in, because they
are just about out of time. They're down by five with 5:45 to go in the game. Gophers come away with the puck. Harris has it. Drop it out to Reed Larson. He cranks up and fires again. One down. He makes the save. And Lambert jumped from behind. I tell you, that one looked like it was by Warden. Larson has got a rifle for a shot out there. But Warden got the stick in the glove, down on top of it and trapped it.
Watch it again. There's a shot by Larson. Good stop by Warden as he covers it up quickly.
Face off to the left of Warden. Minnesota has won every draw on this power play. .535 left to go in the game. Deck leading by the commanding 6-1 margin. Lambert on the draw with Steele. This time Steele gets the draw. Tech has it. They can't clear it out. It comes to Reed Larson. Moves out in front. Larson with the puck. Lines it up. Dumps it over on the side to Ogé. Ogé has it knocked off his stick. He dumps it back into the corner. Lambert hustles back after it. Sends it all the way around the boards. Gophers over to cut it off. Comes out to Reed Larson. Larson to Ogé. He fired. Didn't get much on it. Picked up by Schneider. Well, Schneider tried to center it, knocked down by Lorimer, gets it out to Ogé. Ogé back to Schneider, now out to Reed Larson, cranks up, he shoots, he's wide to the right with his shot. Picked up by Schneider, right out in front, and it's kicked off to the side, picked up by Schneider again. Schneider out to the blue line to Reed Larson. Larson starts to move in, dumps it over for Ogé, he shoots, and Warden steers that one aside. Minnesota has just kept the puck in the Michigan Tech end. 20 seconds left to go on the penalties. Another shot. Now Ogé over to pick it up again. Michigan Tech defense tough out in front. A lot of screening done for Jim Warden. Now here's a shot by Larson. Goes wide to the right. Comes off to Schneider with 7 seconds left. He fires it way wide to the left, and it's picked up by Michigan Tech. They clear it down the ice, and that should just about kill off the penalty time. Both teams are right back at full strength. With 4:24 left to go in the hockey game, now all Tech has to do is sit on that 5-goal lead. As Reed Larson starts back, fires the shot wide to the left. Warden out, couldn't quite get to it, and it's cleared out to the blue line and out to center ice. Ogé has it there, dumps it back in. It's picked off by Tech, and they start back. Zook goes across the Gopher blue line and dumped back out to center ice, picked up out there by Abbey. Abbey retreats towards his own blue line. His pass a little too far, and Ogé picks it off. For Minnesota. Ogé with the puck, has it knocked off his stick. Wilcox trying to move in. He goes down after it, sends it right through the crease. It comes over to the near side, and it's picked up by Warren Miller of Minnesota. He tried to put it on Polich's stick, but it's intercepted by Oslem. Here's a shot by Wilcox. He hit the side of the net, and it's picked up by Robin Larson. He banks it off the boards. Miller clears it out to center ice, and Tech will go back and regroup again. Paul Jensen with it. 3:30 left to go in a hockey game. Tech's almost home. Puck in the Gopher end, kicked out to Miller. Miller dumps it back of the net, comes over to Les Ogé. Michigan Tech checking very well on the Minnesota end right now. They've got him really bottled up. Puck comes out to Dahlheim at center ice, carries across the blue line, gets it around one man. Polich carries on, picks it up back of the net, still has the puck, still has it. Cruises out in front, tried to get it over to the man breaking for the net. Micheletti could not. Micheletti got it and fired the shot wide to the left and steered around the boards by Murray. And cleared out the center ice by Michigan Tech as we're under 3 minutes to go in the hockey game. Puck picked up by Fredrickson. Couldn't control it and it's cleared away from him and picked up by Oslin. Now Michigan Tech starts back. Oslin with a pass off the boards, a little bit too far for Roberts. And Thayer steers that around to the side. Dahlheim faked the firing it behind the net. Now it's picked up by Bouchard. Centering pass out in front, cleared away by the Gophers. As they pick it up, Robin Larson gets it up to Laurent. Laurent for Fredrickson. Cleared back out the center ice by Murray, driven right back in again by Minnesota. Wilcox with it. He steers it out to center ice. It's picked up there by the Gophers with 2 minutes 20 seconds left to go in the hockey game. And Michigan Tech will be your new NCAA champions as the puck's dumped into the Tech zone. Time has run out on Minnesota. Puck picked up by Murray. His pass knocked down by Bedford by Vlad. Held into the Tech zone. Bouchard takes it into the boards. He wants it face off and will have it in the Michigan Tech end with 2:02 left to go. And the chant goes up, we're number one, from the Michigan Tech fans across the way, and they've got a right to do it.
Yeah, we should not be denied to dispute that claim, that's for sure. John McGinnison coming into the game, but he thought his team was really on an upswing, playing very well, scoring well, and doing everything well, and they really have done everything well here tonight.
Face off to the right of Jim Warden in the Tech zone.
the shot fired up there for Minnesota by Russ Anderson. Lyle, puck picked off by Fiffin. Now Morrow drives it, picked off by Lyle. Lyle to the Minnesota blue line, around one man, takes a check from Anderson and goes down. Morrow after the puck, plays it along the new boards, the near boards. He's creamed into the boards back there by Jensen. Jensen in turn knocked down. Lyle with the puck. Fiffin knocks it off his stick. And it's picked up by Vanelli. Vanelli to the blue line. Has it knocked off his stick, goes in after it. They trap it up along the boards. Fiffin has it. Tries to get it out front to Youngins, and that's broken up by Tech. And they come away with it. Young dumps it into the Gopher zone. Fair has to make the save. Anderson with it. We're down to a minute and 19 seconds left to go in the hockey game. Well, the University of Minnesota has valiantly tried to defend their NCAA crown. They had to come from behind to beat Harvard to reach the finals. But Michigan Tech just too much for them tonight. And for this evening, at least, Michigan Tech the better of the two teams, just as a year ago Minnesota was the better of the two in the championship game. Less than a minute to go in the hockey game. Vanelli picked up the puck, driven in by Pippen. Youngins after it. Lorimer got there first. Youngins and Lorimer trap it up along the boards, and that'll bring another faceoff in the Michigan Tech end with 44 seconds left to go. You're going to hear an eruption when this game ends. You may hear it before the game ends from the Michigan Tech fans, and they'll pour out to greet Jim Warden. Don't go away. We'll break and then be right back for any presentations they may have here at the St. Louis Arena. As the NCAA Championships of 1975 are drawing rapidly to a close, and Michigan Tech will wear the crown for the 75-76 season until we do it all over again next year. Wouldn't be a bit surprised to see both teams right back in there, Roger.
I think it's certainly a definite possibility.
Well, for young Herb Brooks, it's got to be a disappointment. The young head coach of the University of Minnesota. In his 3 years, he's brought his team to two NCAA championship games, come home with one, and certainly that's not a bad record. Puck held in by Joe Micheletti. They dump it back of the net. We're down to 39 seconds to go. The puck comes loose on the near boards, picked up by Holmgren. He had his pass deflected, picked off by Younger, out to center ice. Del Vies with it out there, avoids a check, still has the puck, avoids another check, and now gets it over on the side to Younger. Younger checked out of the play by Oje. Puck picked up by Minnesota. They try to get it up to Holmgren. He dumps it in, and Warden steers that one aside. 15 seconds left to go in the game. The puck comes out to center ice. Now fed back to Les Oje. The Gophers dump it back in again. The fans starting to erupt now. 7 seconds. Down to 4, 3, 2, 1. Go over. And the Huskies go out, and they will thoroughly maul Jim Warden. 6 go in the air, and Michigan Tech is the NCAA champion. There they are. Now we'll be back in a moment. The final score, Michigan Tech 6, the University of Minnesota 1.
You've been watching NCAA Hockey, live from St. Louis, Missouri. The championship game between the Michigan Tech Huskies and the Minnesota Golden Gophers.